Humanity has been driven from Earth, but now it's time to take it back. Join the Reconquest and fight the Scourge on the Drop Zone Commander Hub at beastofwar.com. Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastofwar.com.
Hi everybody, welcome to Let's Play Bolt Action. This is an interesting one because we have a beach invasion. John, who are you playing today?
This is the BBC Home Service. Here is the news at 9 o'clock. On the 6th of June 1944, following the loss of the Battle of Britain, the Germans have invaded Britain. Along the south coast, it is estimated that 9 divisions of German infantry and tanks have invaded the south of England. The problems that we have at the moment is that there's not enough forces on the beach to potentially repel the German invasion.
What?
Right, yes.
Okay, that kind of caught me off guard. Right, as you can see, guys, we do have a beautiful beach scenario set up here. Mm-hmm. On my side, of course, I have set up my first wave, so I have some half-tracks sitting down here. I have a teeny weeny little tanky.
Yeah, this is a Panzer II Lux. This is the Lux, tank
yes.
That people have heard me talk about before, and I've gone, oh my god, I really want one, and I eventually got one, so...
Yep.
I'm not getting to play it for the first time. Justin is.
Yep. Next up, what is... Okay, this is one I haven't seen. It looks like my Puma, mm-hmm. but it's not my Puma. What is this?
This was one of the later releases by Warlord.
Right.
It's essentially the Puma.
Yeah.
And they went, needs a bigger gun. But
it only has a teeny-weeny little turret. Is that why they removed my teeny-weeny little turret?
Yeah, we couldn't make enough Stugs, but we had plenty of Pack 40s, so let's take the top off that Puma and let's put a Pack 40 on the top of it instead.
So I have a convertible Puma with a Pack 40.
It's a convertible, yeah.
Okay. Further up the field, I have a medium machine gun.
Mm-hmm.
I have my second lieutenant here, who is joined by a fabulous 10-man squad with an LMG.
Mm-hmm.
Further up from that, I have a half-track with a light anti-tank gun on here. What
yep.
is the light anti-tank gun here? I don't remember, John.
It's one of the 37mm packs. It's not a particularly good gun by the latter stages of the war, but not bad.
Shoot it in him for when he'll know about it.
Oh, yeah, he will.
Then on up from that, I have my other commander, another second lieutenant, with another 10-man squad with an LMG in there.
Yep.
John, what do you have on your side?
First, let me get the proper scenario out.
Okay.
Okay, so let's do a little bit of history here, guys. Let's do a little bit of talk.
History? I'm invading England.
Yeah. Have you watched the movie Jack Boots on Whitehall? No, it's not that. We're not tunneling.
Never before, in the course of human history, has so much been buggered up by so few.
For so many. Anyway, the scenario is basically we were checking out Eriskany's...
Operation Sea Lion.
Operation Sea Lion,
yes.
Yeah. Fantastic little series that we were watching and looking at it going, that's cool. Let's do something in inspiration of that.
Yeah.
So I came up with this scenario and ran a little bit of background through my head, and I basically went, what scenarios had to happen to lead up to the Germans even attempting to invade Britain?
Right.
The main one is that Britain lost the Battle of Britain.
Yep.
The RAF was put back in its cage, didn't, you know, took a beating off the Luftwaffe. The Luftwaffe just kept air supremacy the entire time.
Mm.
So the history behind this scenario is that we lost the Battle of Britain. After that, the Germans realized we can't really mount the invasion properly. Yes, we have all the barges and stuff, but they're not as good and we don't have as much of the stuff as what we need.
Mm.
So what Germany then did, what Hitler and the others decided to do was focus on the Luftwaffe's air supremacy
yep.
and focus on the U-boat campaign in the Atlantic.
Right.
So they focused that. Admiral Dönitz got all the U-boats he wanted. He got 200-plus U-boats in the sea, and he's effectively cutting Britain off from all the supplies coming in from America.
Right.
Because of the threat of the U-boat campaign in the Atlantic, the Americans, having joined the war in 1941, cannot get their troop ships and stuff across. They're very unwilling to send that amount of hardware and men across.
Yeah.
So the build-up for what would have been D-Day in Normandy
yeah.
hasn't happened in this scenario.
Instead, in Calais...
Instead, what has actually happened is that the Brits have had to sit here, they're getting supplies from America, but it's in dribs and drabs, no major movement of American troops over to England, so there's not that big build-up.
Yeah.
The next thing that had to happen was Russia did continue, or Germany did continue with the invasion of Russia.
Yes.
That happened as normal, but with a bit more of a security safety net behind them going, Britain can't do anything, we have them pinned down.
Yeah.
That's grand, we can devote our resources to Russia. Start of 44, mid 44, things are not going so well for them. They realize the Russians are starting to push them back. Mm. So what are they going to have to do? Well, there's still that threat of Britain over there. It can't be an offensive force, but it is a thorn in the side. They can still mount attacks from there.
Yeah, that, and if the U-boat campaign suddenly takes a swing for the worse, they have to know that then America will... Well, America's had more time to build up. They have tons and tons of stuff waiting on their side of the Atlantic, ready to be shipped across to England to actually hit Europe.
Yeah, but in this scenario, what actually happened in this scenario, this completely made-up scenario, because the Americans couldn't get the resources across the Atlantic, the whole Germany first policy that was put together in one of the first early conferences between the big three wasn't agreed on. Mm. America's went to the Pacific with 80% of its forces. Mm. They've went, Japan is our biggest enemy right now. We cannot help Britain other than
Pearl Harbor still happened, yeah?
Yep. Everything else still happened around this.
Yeah.
But a couple of key things have been tweaked for this scenario to make this possible.
Okay.
So,
I have opened the corridor to
You've
the south
opened
of
the corridor. Germany's desperate now. As the Russians are starting to push them back, Germany's went, we need to mop up Britain. We need to make Britain supplicant so that we can move stuff across there.
Yeah.
Because if Russia comes our way, we need something already in place to start a counter push.
Yeah.
At some point. So we need to wipe up Britain now.
So, hence, here we are.
Hence D-Day on the south coast of England.
Yes.
So what the British have here is, in my little scenario, I kind of have this as one of the more outlying parts of the south coast, way over by Cornwall or something like that. Some of these nice little beaches you see along the south coast. Because it's not as close to Europe, the defences aren't as good as the stuff around the ports.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, looking at the table, we have a set of three bunkers up the table.
Yeah.
Now, I'm assuming these are going to be key for our scenario, yeah?
They will be, yeah. My objective is to hold you at the water edge. This is something that is important for every seaborne invasion. I have to stop you getting off the beach.
Yeah.
That basically means that these three bunkers are our objective points. I have to hold these bunkers.
Yep.
I have to reinforce them if needs be. I need to get reserves in. You, on the other hand, have to clear out the bunkers through any means necessary, satchel charges or getting in there and getting the infantry out.
Yeah.
And they are the victory condition. You get these bunkers, I cannot get enough
stuff
forward.
I've got my toehold.
Yeah.
I've got my toehold. Now, the real key for me here is, any beach invasion is always, always a real pain in the ass. Because as you can see on the tabletop, the beach is quite bare. You know, there's maybe a little bit of cover here. You know, that's actually really tempting me to just have stuff moving up to that and maybe take position. Across here, we've got the road out of the beach. Again, very tempting. So I think I'm going to have to use vehicles as like mobile cover and stuff.
Yep.
To actually just give me that breathing room, that way to get up the beach to you before I get cut down by Bren gunfire.
Yep. So what we have on the beach is that there are two main draws, is what they call them, draws off the beach. Mm. We have this one over here, which has got the concrete walls and stuff around it. This is a sort of typical setup you would find on any beach that's been fortified, because this is where it would allow friendly forces to come on and do maintenance and work on the beach. Mm-hmm. This one is open. And it's very inviting, isn't it?
It's very inviting, aside from the fact that there's those boxcars up the front, because, I mean, like, this area of the coastline, I'm guessing, has probably taken a major pasting before my stuff has landed.
Whatever German Navy could get to this part of the coast will have shelled this relentlessly for at least a couple of hours.
Yeah.
So anything around here has been destroyed. This train has obviously come off in the resulting explosions.
Yeah, yeah.
However, there is a problem.
Okay.
You are attacking a beach that has had 4+ years time to be fortified, be checked, make sure everything's ready.
Yeah, and this is just one segment of it.
And this is one segment of it. Now, you have minefields to worry about.
Okay, right. I'll tell you what, this is your scenario.
Mm-hmm.
So don't you tell me where the minefields are.
Right, I won't tell you where the minefields are.
Because I'm looking at it, there's a couple of inviting spots, right? Mm-hmm. Now, up through here, there's a bit of cover I can go for. I can actually get past sort of the enfilading fire.
Yep.
Over here, it looks a little bit tougher, but again, it's a nice clean draw off the beach. If I can take that, I've got a good toehold, I've got a good base to actually start the rest of the operations further inland.
Yeah. So what we'll do is, right, You turn away. You turn your back to me right now.
Okay. What camera do you want to put
No, just keep
out?
It. Keep it on that one.
Okay.
I'll tell you if you need to change cameras.
All right. Well, I've got my
so
fingers on the buttons.
My minefield is that location. So can you switch camera to top down, please, Justin?
Which one do you want? Do you want two?
Yeah. Two is fine. So this is the area that has the minefields in it. So that's what Justin's going to have to worry about. So you can turn back.
Okay. See how high-tech we are on camera? Justin, turn away!
Turn away.
All right, so... Guys, you're probably going to be screaming at me, Not that one! And I'm just going to be going, I need to get up off this beach.
Yeah.
Okay, so, need to begin the game. As everybody can see, I've kind of caught the British by surprise. I've got all my troops. My first wave is down on the beach. We are going to be running rolling reserves for this. So as stuff dies, it can come back.
Yeah.
Because that's how I think you do a beach scenario and make it fun.
Yeah.
That you don't just get locked down, your stuff gets pasted, and then you have nothing to back you up.
The main thing to remember when you're playing a beach invasion scenario is that this little stretch of sand is where everybody's attention is. Mm. At Normandy, you've seen that specifically. You had, 50-odd miles of beachfront. Everything in that area was focused on that little stretch of sand.
Yeah.
So behind the beach on the British side, we have guys in here with radio sets going, there is stuff coming, send help now. So everything in the local area is starting to wake up, get mobilized, and start moving.
Yeah.
Same on the German side. Offshore, the entire invasion fleet is there. If they hear
it's
a call
for reserves...
It's in the
metaphysical ocean which I'm standing in.
Yeah. If they hear reserves being called for... It's coming in immediately.
Yeah.
So the idea of having rolling reserves is that as stuff gets blown up, everybody is getting situation reports and going, we need more tanks, we need more infantry, send in another wave of this.
Yep.
That keeps the game going, keeps the firefighting intense, and keeps the objectives highly contested.
Yeah.
That's what I think, anyway.
All right, now, John, quick question again for the minefields. Have you decided how they're going to work?
Yes. If you choose to move at your normal speed with a vehicle, for example, at the end of your normal speed movement, which I think in a half track's what, about 9 inches?
I think it's 9 inches.
Eight or nine inches.
Right. At the end, I have the handy dandy rule book. And if you are actually looking for all of this,
it's at the back of
the book. You can literally go right to the back of the book because they've just got a few pages dedicated to your movement, what your HE does, what your weapon chart is. So movement on tracked vehicles is 9.
Yep.
Half tracked vehicles is 9. Wheeled vehicles is 12, infantry 6.
Yeah.
So we are playing with the second edition rules.
Mm-hmm. So at the end of his movement, in the mined area that I know and you guys know, he has to roll a dice.
Yes.
If he rolls a 6, that vehicle is immediately immobilized.
Ah.
So it's hit an anti-tank mine or a mine that isn't powerful enough to take a wheel off or break the track.
Yeah.
The last thing you want to be doing in a beach invasion is getting out of your vehicle and starting to repair a track under fire.
Yeah.
You'll sit in your tank or you'll abandon it.
Well, you see, if I get immobilized, I'm not overly worried because I then become a mobile pillbox. I become that terrain that I want on the tabletop.
Yeah. You're still not useless, but you are limited then.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, so you're saying if I move at half, I don't set it off?
If you move at your normal distance,
you'll
complete your distance and roll the dice.
Right.
If you want to move slower than that, let's say you want to move at half that, you really want to crawl to let your infantry keep up with you.
Mm.
Halfway through that movement, you'll have to roll a dice.
Okay.
So you're moving carefully, but there's still a little bit of edginess to it.
All right, we'll see what happens, right? So
actually, no. Do you know what? We'll make it fair. If you're moving really slow, you're moving very carefully, so he doesn't roll.
Okay.
If you move at normal, any sort of normal speed in the book, roll at the end of the movement.
Okay. Let's get stuck in. So as it stands, all of my guys, they're regular because, they've been through the campaigns in Europe. They know what they're up to, and I don't really have the raw recruits to throw at a beach, I would say.
Well, at the same time, you're not going to want to put your veterans right up front on a beach invasion where
trust me, they're waiting in the second lines. Again, that's the other thing. We are kind of throwing points out the window for this one.
We have, so, and
this
army
is
lists.
A bring what you have kind of a game. So, if you see us doing stuff, we break force org, it's fine. We know what we're doing.
Yep. So, in this instance, the Germans' first wave is regular. The British first wave, the British guys that are holding these bunkers at the minute are veteran.
Mm.
These are guys that have been taken out of Africa and stuff.
That made it back from Dunkirk.
Yeah, the guys that made it back from Dunkirk, the guys that survived the Africa campaign and have come back to help the British Isles defend itself.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's get stuck in. So I've got my first dice.
Yep.
And what I'm going to do with that first dice is, you see the teeny-weeny little tank here?
Yep, your Lux.
Yeah, I'm going to give it just an advance order.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll have a 9-inch move to do here.
Grand.
And from there, I'm just going to have it do its regular 9-inch move straight up the field.
Mm-hmm.
So he'll just go up to there and take his dice with him.
That's great. Roll a mind dice.
Roll what?
Roll a mind dice.
Oh, okay. Right, now that I've discovered where the minefield is, can you tell me which section it is, or are we sectioning it, or how are we denoting where it begins and ends?
Don't know, just you. I'm not telling you anything. You have to figure this out on your own.
Okay. Well, I suppose you would have in actual warfare. So on a 6, he's immobilized.
Yep, on a 6, he's immobilized.
A 1.
1. He's okay.
He's fine.
He's fine this turn.
Okay, so I have my autocannon.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to have a quick look, because I don't... Oh, wait, no.
What are you doing? Don't put the dice back in the back.
Doing silly stuff. All right, so let me call up the weapon chart here just for handiness.
Mm-hmm.
Weapon chart. It is at the back of the book, I swear.
Yeah, it is somewhere.
I've got it. Okay. So, autocannon, you say that has.
Yep. Light automatic cannon.
You're sure this is... light automatic cannon. Okay, range 48, 2 shots.
Mm-hmm.
Pen 2 plus. And it's got a hitchy 1. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have him turn his turret.
And he's going to point at that bunker.
He's going to point at this bunker.
Okay.
And he'll take a shot.
Now, right.
I assume you're in hard cover.
Very, yeah.
So, starts on 3.
Mm-hmm.
I've moved, goes to 4.
Yep.
Hard cover is a 6.
Yep.
So, 2 shots on a 6, yeah?
Yep.
Nothing.
So nothing. Okay.
So ping ping, taking chunks out of the concrete.
Yep.
All right. That's his activation done.
Ground.
Me again.
Okay, go for it.
Right, I'm going to be sneaky. So I'm going to activate this.
Yep.
And I'm going to risk it. I'm going to give it an advance order.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to have it advance. I want to see if I can find where the extent of this minefield is. So mm-hmm. I'll roll up to here.
Yep. Roll mine dice.
God damn it, really?
Yep.
Right. See, I was hoping it was just like maybe a 12-inch zone from like the center of that stick or something.
Yeah.
You're probably just cackling inside. Okay, so mind dice.
Inside? I'm cackling outside.
Yeah. Yeah, do I know one thing?
Mm.
That's his mind dice.
Yeah, I know.
4, he's fine.
He's okay.
Okay. I'm wondering, will it get denser as I get further inland? Will I have to roll a 5 up on the next one?
That would be brilliant. I hadn't thought of that, actually. That's a good idea.
Oh, never do. Oh. I need to keep my mouth closed on these
kind
of things.
Yes, you do.
Okay.
So he doesn't really have any viable targets now because...
Yes, he moved a little too far forward.
Yeah, he moved a bit far and his front arc is...
I assume this is a fixed 45-degree weapon, but it does mean that once I'm here, I actually have this covered.
Yes.
Which is what I was worried about, because I know you are going to have to start bringing armor in soon.
Yep.
And we are going to use regular reserve rules, but we're using them on turn 1. So on like a 4+, you can bring stuff in off the table.
Mm-hmm.
Me again.
Yeah.
It's all coming up, Justin.
All the initiative. So what are you going to do now?
All right. I'm going to try this half track here with the light anti-tank gun.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to give him an advance order. I am just going to be risking it for a while till I find where the hell this minefield ends. Yep.
Okay.
So I'll have him roll up to about here.
Grand.
And that'll just mean that my infantry is sort of shielded from this other squad you have at the top of the table.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a mind dice?
Nope.
No mind dice. So, good. I was worried that it would just say, whenever my back was turning, just doing...
Just all of it!
Everything!
I should have.
Nah, play fair. All right, so it's a light anti-tank gun I've got on there, yeah?
Yeah.
Light anti-tank gun, range 48. It's a 1-shot.
Mm-hmm.
So I've moved, you're in hardcover. It's going to be a 6 to hit you.
Yep.
And I'm shooting at these guys, but yep. I miss anyway.
Miss anyway.
Gloriously missing.
You're panicked. Your adrenaline's up. You're not aiming properly. You're going to be shot at in a minute.
I'm going to be shot at right now.
You're going to be shot at right now, yes.
So there's one for you.
Yep.
What are you going to do with it? Are you going to try and bring reserves on, or do you think you can hold a little while longer while the rest of my stuff activates?
I need to look over at my reserve table and see if there's anything I think needs to be here.
Well, I don't really have anything too heavy at the minute, so...
No, you don't. I would need some some more machine guns on the field. No, do you know what? We're going to hold with what we've got, and we're going to try and start dealing some damage to you.
Okay. Three plucky squads of British infantrymen holding against the waves and waves of Germans coming up the beach.
It's all right. It's fine. So, in the central bunker,
yeah,
everybody has a five-man unit in these bunkers.
Yeah.
Their veterancy is veteran.
Yeah.
They have an LMG and four rifles.
Yes.
This unit in the middle is going to open fire on your machine gun team.
Okay, my MMG team right here.
Yep. So they've seen the MMG coming up. The guys are lying down in the sand. They're like, priority target that because he is a suppressive weapon. We need to get rid of that quick.
Yeah.
So these guys are going to be issued with the fire order.
Okay.
Now, an LMG in version 2 is what? 3 shots, 4 shots?
Light machine gun is 4 shots.
4 shots. Okay.
So and give them white.
Plus 4 rifles.
But is one guy a loader, or does the brain gun not have that?
Oh, the brain gun does have that, yeah. So 3 rifle shots.
Ta-da! Mm-hmm. See? Keep you right, mate.
I think so, anyway. So,
well, red, if we're wrong, put it in the comments, but that's how we remember it.
Red dice rifle, white dice LMG.
Yep.
Firing at your MMG team.
All right, fire away. Where do I want to go down?
You're open, so you have no save currently. Mm. So if you go down, you're basically hunkering into the sand a bit.
Yeah. Although, are those rifles... Are you within 12?
Ah, there is a good point.
So on the tabletop, you are within 12.
I am within 12.
So it will just be flat threes unless I decide to go down.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, hell with that. I'll take it on the chin. There's
okay.
There's more on the boat.
Okay. So here we go. Threes.
Three misses.
Three misses. And 4 hits.
Mm-hmm. So with me being a veteran...
Yep. It's still a pin marker because I'm still firing at you.
It is. It is. So I'll pop a pin marker down onto here.
Yep.
Just to keep us in the right. So I'm just looking at where to kills. Kills. Group quality morale. Isn't it fours to kill or is it five to kill?
I think it's fours. I'm pretty sure it's fours.
Hit modifiers. Ah, here we are. Veteran infantry is 5+.
Five plus. Okay.
Yep. All soft skin vehicles are 6. So it's inexperienced 3, regular 4. Or no, these are regular.
Yeah.
So it is 4. Damn, you see, this is the thing. I am used to running veteran Germans. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
They are dead.
Yep. That just went skadoosh.
That team is gone.
So that team is completely gone and dead. Now, I do have my reserve table just slightly off camera.
Mm-hmm. Great. So, not bad for the opening salvo of the British defence.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. Our activation is complete. Over to you.
Yeah. Now, the one other thing we have done is we've put a set number of activations in the bag.
Yeah.
Because we do have quite a bit of stuff.
Our armies are about 15 units worth.
Yeah.
The stuff we have laid out on the tables, like our two reserve tables, there's 15 units in total that we can rotate through. Mm-hmm. However, we're only running 10 dice each in the bag.
10 dice each in the bag. It's kind of to show that this would be really, really frantic.
Yeah.
You know. All right, so I've got an order dice here.
Mm-hmm.
I know, I'm pretty sure this segment of beach is clear now, right?
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to issue a... I'll issue an advance order to my regular squad.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, they are just going to move 6 inches up the field. Get everybody moving up. That's how we do it.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is my death or glory charge here. At that, and you've activated, so I know until next turn I'm kind of safe.
I think every forward movement you make on a beach is a death or glory charge.
Yeah, but I'm thinking because that nest has now went,
mm-hmm.
I'm okay to move up and fire with this squad, right?
Yep.
So I've got an LMG in there.
Yep.
So it would be 4 shots. But because of Hitler's buzzsaw, it does affect lights, so that becomes 5.
Mm-hmm.
I then got an NCO who has an assault rifle, so that's an additional 2 shots.
Mm-hmm.
And I've then got 8 riflemen, but 1's a looter, so mm-hmm. another 7 die. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's perfect. So all the dice are different colors. So white for rifle, blue for
assault rifle,
red for
LMG.
Now, I've moved You're in hardcover, but yep. I am under half range.
Yep.
So this is very tight very quickly, but I need sixes on a good handful of dice. I got one.
You got two.
Two?
You have two, one of your LMGs.
Ah, nice. Okay, but it is still only the one pin into your unit here.
Yep.
But it means that your guys are veterans, so I need fives to kill, yeah?
Yep.
All right, let me just gather in the dice and keep our mat nice and clear of clutter. You know, don't let there be clutter on your beaches, people. Keep them clean. Keep them nice. All right, so need fives to kill.
Yep.
One dead.
One. Okay.
Not exceptional, but it'll do. I'll take it.
So I'll take a rifleman out the back here.
Excellent. And he'll live with that.
Over here.
Yeah.
Great.
Yep. So that's done. Their advanced dice will go with them.
Great.
More death.
More death.
Deathness.
Right. Let me see here. Aha! Now, hidden back here, watching what's going on, are two little men in a house over here.
Yeah.
So I have a sniper team set up.
Oh,
just off the beach.
Yeah.
Now, because the sniper team is ideally situated, we have a ridiculously good angle of fire here. So I'm looking at...
Who would you like to kill?
I'm looking at this second lieutenant over here in the surf.
This guy right here at the back?
Yep. I think I can shoot him.
Okay.
I certainly have kind of a line of sight to him. Mm-hmm. I have to look through the other squad, so...
Your sniper rifle is a standard rifle.
Yep.
So it's 24-inch range.
It's 24-inch range.
So...
But I don't believe I suffer a range penalty because of it being a sniper rifle. I cannot remember.
I'll give it to you.
Yeah.
I'll give it to you. But let's see if you're actually in range. You're not.
I'm not. Ah.
So, looking at this, you can see
you're
about 4 inches out of range.
Mm-hmm. So.
Sorry, I will let you pick another target if you want.
Yeah, that's fine. The sniper team one will target this unit that's been moving up here.
Yep, okay.
So we'll issue a fire order to them. Fire order.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to... I can pick my target in the squad, can't I?
You can pick who dies.
Yeah, okay. So he's going to fire at the unit. Single dice.
Yep.
And let me see here.
Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun. Does the NCO get it?
Dun 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 dun. Three.
That'll hit.
Will it?
Well, if you think, you're not taking that range penalty.
Yep.
I have no cover. I'm not down. So, boom.
Yeah, okay.
So, you'll need a four to kill.
Yes, I will. Six.
To kill. Okay, so who would you like?
The LMG.
Damn it. Okay.
Why would I want to get rid of the NCO? I'll just take the LMG.
Alright, I need to find the LMG.
He's at the back row.
Back
row. Over your finger. There he is.
So, one little German dies. Who was it? Because these are the ones that were painted by Satinius Polinius. Alphonse! No!
Alphonse, he knew my bullet well.
Okay. Alright, so they're done.
Uh-huh.
I didn't realize you had a sniper team back there.
Yeah.
It you actually would because, you know, they'd be scouting for everybody. Oh, crap, it's you again.
No, the problem is I'm running out of targets.
Yeah.
Because there's stuff that's activated and the other stuff that's moving is armored.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to be
Do you have an armored reserve that you could perhaps call in? Of course you do. It's John. Of course he has tanks.
There are If I was playing this without tanks, I should be in hospital. There'd be something wrong.
Yeah.
All right. This unit over here at the far end of the beach.
Yeah, so way, way up here.
Way over here. They're a duplicate of every other unit on the field, so it's five man with an LMG and four rifles.
Yeah.
They're going to open up on this unit over here.
Ah, so my squad that's still down on the surf. Now, there is a...
There's a second lieutenant with them.
Yep. Just so you know.
So we're going to issue them with a fire order.
Yeah.
Two of them are not in the bunker. The LMG is. So the way I have it, because of the size of the bunker, only the LMG and two of the rifles can fire.
Makes sense, because it's a smaller bunker.
Yep. So all three can fire, because we'll assume one of the guys in the back is the loader for the LMG, because he's in the bunker with the guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the way I'm going to work it. Right. So we need four
for your LMG.
For the LMG and two rifle shots, please.
Two rifle shots. There you go.
So I haven't moved.
But you will be over 12.
I am over 12.
So
the rifles. The rifles are at four?
Yeah, the rifles are at four. Your LMG has a range of 36.
Yeah, so it's
that becomes 18.
Yep.
And 18 is well in.
Yeah. And you're not in cover. Now, do you want to go down or not?
No, I cannot hang about here.
All right.
So, on the chin.
Well, practically, yeah, the LMG missed once.
Yep, so that's three from the LMG.
And nothing from the rifles?
Nothing from the rifles.
Okay, so three shots from the LMG.
Yep.
So
fourth to kill.
Your first pin marker.
Yes.
And fours to white, to hurt and kill.
Yep. Nada.
Nada, but there's a pin marker down there.
But that does kind of feel like what would happen from a pillbox like that. You don't really have a great angle of fire, so you're just literally hosing down the beach.
Yep. Chucking those 303 rounds out like it's cool.
Well, chucking them out like it's going out of fashion.
Yeah.
You again?
It's me again.
I think you're going to be forced to bring in your reserves here.
Yeah, I think at this point I will, because the unit over at the far end only has half tracks to look at. So, yeah, it's about time I try and get some reserves in.
Now, the way we're doing this, guys, is, if I remember what you told me, John, is we're starting on a 4.
Mm-hmm.
Next turn becomes a 3, and then it just stays a 3 for the rest of the game. Yeah?
Yeah,
and we're playing
right.
A 5-turn game.
Okay. I'm going to try and get one of the Bren gun carriers in.
Okay.
Because they have another 5-man unit with them.
Oh, I see.
So there's 3 of those with 3 more 5-man squads in there.
Yeah.
Or sections.
What I'm kind of getting the feeling of is here, you're going to try and hold this wall line.
Yeah, pretty much. So I have my activation dice. I need one dice to make sure that they're to roll to them in.
So on a 4 up.
On a 4.
Or are they sitting sleeping at home?
Please don't be sleeping.
They're not.
They're in.
They're awake. Engine's fired up.
We now have a carrier coming on board.
Yeah.
Which is great for me because he has a couple of LMGs.
Yeah.
And the squad section, it doesn't have an LMG. So they might just stay mounted in this thing and get them going.
Yeah, now don't forget your transport rules, because if I get closer to that than you, it'll run away.
It's
going, not today.
It's a problem. So the carrier's going to come in at full tilt.
Yeah.
Going to drive in as fast as he can.
All right, now he's a tracked vehicle.
He's a tracked vehicle.
Yeah, so you'll have 18 inches.
Mm-hmm. Can you give me the tape measure, please?
Yes, I can.
So 18 inches.
Yeah.
Which gives me a full range of movement up to behind this bunker.
Yeah, but you won't be firing this turn, which I can live with.
No. My advance would be 9 inches.
It would be 9, yeah.
Yep. So 9 would bring me to... Not close enough. So I do need to come in at the run.
Aye.
So
I think a lot of your stuff is going to have to pelt down to the beach to actually take up position.
Yep. So the carrier is here.
Yep.
He's coming in a straight line.
Yep.
Being told that all sorts of stuff is going on here.
Yep. Yep. The Germans are coming! The Germans are coming!
Yep.
Okay, so we'll go for our next dice.
Mm-hmm.
It's me. Where do I want to go? See, this end, I'm pretty much happy to leave that alone. There's a squad down here that hasn't went yet.
Yep.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to activate one of my half tracks down here.
Mm-hmm.
It'll have a 9-inch move of tape.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. This is risky business, because I'm kind of thinking, has John just split the table in two and said this entire half is mined? So I'll activate this one, and I will send him up through to here.
Yep. Roll a mine dice.
See, that makes me nervous. So it's a regular advance.
Yep.
So I'll just find the advanced side, and I will roll. That's mine dice.
Mm-hmm.
A one,
so he's okay.
You need to talk to your munitions factory here, John.
You just didn't hit any of them.
All right, then you need to talk to the people that are spreading them. All right, so on that, there is a medium machine gun, yeah?
Yep.
So from here, I'm going to be firing down into that bunker there.
Yep, so he's on the frontal arc.
Yeah, so medium machine gun. Lovely, 5 dice to begin.
Mm-hmm. Important thing is, though, can he see through the slit from where he is off the 45-degree angle?
Yes.
You sure?
I would say so, because
okay.
From the actual point of the gun,
yep.
At that 45-degree angle, I think I can get it.
Okay. So he's trying to do the sort of western ricochet into the bunker sort of thing. Yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
But because it's a medium machine gun, I get 6 dice this time.
Yep.
Which should hopefully help. So 6s, because I've moved and you're in hard cover. I got 1.
Yep, okay.
That'll be a pin marker for these guys down in here.
Yep.
I'll just put it outside.
Yeah, so we know.
And I need a 5 to kill a guy.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody died.
That's fine.
So basically, shots flying in through the slit, and then just ducking going, nope!
The bunkers are doing their job.
They really are.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Right.
Next activation.
Yes, next activation. If I remember, I put the bag. Ooh, it's you.
Over to me.
It's you.
I'm going to try and get another Brengan carrier on the field.
Okay.
With another squad.
Yep. So four up.
Yep, a four up.
See if you get it.
No.
One.
Nothing.
So this one's having engine trouble. It's a cold morning, trying to get a Brengan car to start on a cold morning. Not so easy.
The couriers.
Well,
yeah. Sitting in the carrier, pulling the starter handle, going, don't flood, don't flood, don't flood, you flooded.
I think one of the best ones you ever did was, what was it, your half track when you had it. Your dad had two fuel taps on it.
Yep.
Turned the wrong one, driving down the road and she just stopped.
In the middle of a bridge. In the middle of a very tall bridge. A dual carriageway bridge, no less.
Oh, lovely.
Right. Third carrier, then, we're going to try and do the same again.
Yeah.
I'm starting to feel a little bit worried that stuff isn't arriving right away, so...
Five.
Thank goodness for that. So we have a carrier coming on board.
Yeah. So bring it in.
Which is great. Now, he's going to come in over here, I think. Yeah, he's going to come in over there, I think.
Okay.
Far, more at the further end of the table.
Yeah, you're looking to do a little bit more of a support.
Yep, that tape measure.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Right. He's not going to be able to run because he's got a lot of weaving to do in here, so...
Yeah, so it's just going to be a 9-inch on?
Yeah, he's going to be a 9-inch advance from the table edge, which brings him to about here.
But you might still be in range to shoot, although I would call soft cover because of just how many friggin' fences are in the way.
I honestly don't think the brand guns, an LMG, is good enough to get through a half-track. I'm not sure. I can't remember.
Oh, is it only an LMG it has?
Yeah.
Well, it actually doesn't have a pen value, so yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So it won't be able to do it. That's fine. But it's there.
But with them being regular, you would then, after you hit, you have to roll to actually see if they act as regular or if they act as an experience. Or if they act as veteran or inexperienced for the actual morale. You might be able to throw pins onto it.
Yeah, I'd still have the chance of pinning the vehicle, but...
Do you want to?
No, okay. Do you know what? That's fine.
All right.
Next dice, then, because that's all I can do.
All right, now I've got a fair bit of my dice out now, so it should come up, John. It does.
Yep. Now, the unit in the carrier is going to get out.
Yeah.
So I have five men coming in.
Yeah. So they're bailing out from over here.
They're over here, yep.
Yeah, and then they've got the regular 6-inch move.
Yep. No. I don't know if this is necessarily a good idea, but I do definitely think I need to shore up this flank a little bit.
Okay.
So these guys are going to advance.
Yeah.
And they're going to get 6 inches away from the carrier.
Yep.
So...
Up and across the rail lines.
Yep.
That was one of the interesting things I always wondered about was the Home Guard for the UK.
Mm.
They were actually trained guys who actually were, you know, told, look, if Germany invades... You're going to go to this location, you're going to blow up this rail line, deny them supply, deny them the ability to function within our country, which was really scary. And some of it's actually really dark, too.
Yeah, there is a very dark side to the Home Guard that not even the regular Home Guard were told about.
Yeah.
In fact, should I just briefly?
Briefly.
Okay, briefly. There was a few people in the Home Guard, like...
Don't name names.
I don't know any names. But the likes of, you know, like bank clerks, you know, respected, trusted people in the communities were pulled aside by the likes of the SOE or is it the early version of MI6 or whatever, you know, the special ops people that were at the head, the top of the Home Guard, the really secretive part. And they were basically handed a set of instructions that they had to open in the case of German invasion. These instructions included assassination of other local people that were either considered too important to be captured or not reliable enough.
Possibly collaborators.
Yes. So even mayors were on that list. You know, some of those people had to walk up.
Scary stuff.
Yeah. Really dark stuff.
Yeah. You know, scariest environment imaginable. That's all you had to say. Scariest environment imaginable.
I don't know. Soviet Russia?
Yeah, that was pretty bad.
Yep. Anyway, right. Onwards.
Yeah.
So these guys have advanced.
Yeah. Take the dice with them. Are they going to fire while on the move? Or no, there's nothing really to shoot at.
No, not at the moment.
That's fine. So, it is me. You know what? I'm going to try and bring on something to scare you, John.
Okay.
I have some armor, but not much. So I'm going to try and bring on something heavy that I brought along.
Mm-hmm.
Just for you, John.
Okay.
I brought a Panther.
Lovely.
So on a 4-up, my Panther is, you know, on the barge, ready to land on the beach. If not, I'm kind of knackered.
Mm-hmm.
So from here, he turns up.
Oh, great.
Awesome.
That's exactly what I needed.
Oh, come on. Everybody loves kitties.
Yeah.
There it is. Look at it. It's pretty. So he's getting a run order, because I think coming off the waves here and coming in really needs to be quick. So I'm guessing, basically from what I've deduced so far, I'm guessing the minefield stops about here and just is going to run all the way down that table, all right?
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to come on at the run from here. So tape measure.
Mm-hmm.
He'll have 18 inches. I think he's going to want to come straight up the draw.
Yeah, I'd say that's where you'd want to place a tank.
Because I'm hoping that's where your own tanks will come from. Mm-hmm. Now, because I've ran, I don't get a shoot.
Yep.
But I think I can live with that. So he'll get his run order beside him.
That's a very nice looking Panther too. I wonder who painted that.
Ah, oh, John.
Is that why it went missing from my cabinet? When were you in my house?
John, I'm always in your house. Even when you don't know it.
Well.
Only joking.
Ha ha ha. Okay, so now that there's armor on the beach, I need to figure out, is it time for my armor yet? And yes, it is very much so time for my armor to try and get on. So I have a little bit of armor reserve back here.
A little bit of armor. I'm seeing a small division sitting there.
Well, there is a full troop of Shermans over there that need to start letting their presence be known.
Yes.
So I'm going to first roll, because that Panther is there, I'm first going to roll for the Firefly.
Okay, so 4-up, see if the Firefly's awake. Is the engine running? It is.
It is.
Oh, dearie me.
The Firefly is going to turn up. And we're going to give the Firefly an advance order. He's going to come in from back here.
Yep.
Yeah, he's going to come in from here, and he's going to advance 9 inches.
Yep.
So a tape measure.
Yep, there you go.
Now, to make the 9 inches viable for me, without knocking
over...
the
scenery.
Yeah, if I don't destroy the table, I need to keep out a line of sight of that.
Yes.
Because that will hurt, but I need to make myself in line of sight of the Panther. So, let's see, 9
trundle,
inches.
Trundle, trundle.
Trundle, 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 growl, growl, growl. Big kitty, annoyed kitty. 9 inches is going to bring him to just behind here.
Okay.
And he's in a good little bit of cover there.
Yeah, I will say you're going to be getting the front of the tank, but I'm not going to call cover because you can see pretty much the entire front plate.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so moved.
The Panther has got a little bit of an opponent against him now. Yeah.
Now, you can shoot.
Yes, I can, which
so
I will.
What is it you have? Super heavy anti-tank gun, heavy anti-tank gun?
Super heavy anti-tank gun on the fire.
Okay, range 84, so you're definitely within half.
Yep.
One shot.
Eek!
So you've moved, so that's 4, and I think that's it.
Yeah.
Just a 4 to hit my Panther. This is a good chance for you.
No.
2.
It's the way that the dice just plopped as well. I was like, no!
The sand dice, or the sandbar just went, I'm gonna have this.
I want this. Right now. Okay, so Firefly's turned up and missed, but it's important that he's here now.
Yes.
So you've got something to think about in the next time that Panther activates.
Yeah, and it's me again.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. You know what? I'm gonna be mean.
You're gonna bring more armor?
I'm gonna try and bring I have a Panzer 4 sitting waiting, you know, just on the barges waiting to come in.
And as I look over there, it suspiciously looks like one that I own too.
Yes, I have been borrowing. Ah, he arrives. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually move this up at the run.
Mm-hmm.
18 inches.
Bring him up alongside the Panther.
Yeah, bring him up alongside the Panther, but more importantly, I'm going to provide a little bit of mobile cover, like what I talked about earlier, for my infantry section up here who still have to go.
Mm-hmm.
So he'll take his run order with him. There.
Yep.
Shoot.
That's me. Right, I'm going to try and get another reserve on the go here.
Okay. Who'll it be?
I have an armored car in reserve that I'm going to try and bring on.
Oh, what is it, little Daimler?
Yep, little Daimler. So he's going to try and get on board now. So 4 pluses.
Mm-hmm. He gets it.
He gets it. Okay, Daimler's going to come in back here.
Yeah, okay.
He's going to move his 12 inches.
Yeah.
His 12 inches will get him past my Bren gun carrier.
Yeah.
So he'll squeeze round to here.
Uh-huh. And what is it armed with?
It's a light anti-tank gun.
Lovely. Okay.
I'm going to go for the half-track that's still in the water.
Oh, right. So way back here, I have another one that's still just... in the breakers waiting to move up. I had actually forgot about that because it was hidden behind the dice bag. Whoopsie.
It's a good perspective for me then. Right, so my stats on my light anti-tank gun then, please, Justin.
Okay, so one light anti-tank gun.
Mm-hmm. It's single shot.
Yep, range 48, and it's 4 plus on the pen.
Yep, so I believe I'm over half, 24 inches.
Yeah, you are over your half there.
Yep.
Trying to reach it.
So that's a plus one to that, and plus one to move, yep. Because it's moved.
So that's five.
Fives to hit him.
Yeah.
All right, let's do this.
Six. It lands.
It does.
Okay, so you've landed. Mm-hmm. You now need to penetrate it, right?
Yep.
So this is a light armored vehicle, yeah?
Yep.
So armored car carrier is a 7, right?
Mm-hmm.
Roll the dice and add your 4 to it.
Okay.
One.
5. Brings it up to.
5. It doesn't beat it.
Doesn't beat it.
Bong.
Yep, so it's pinged off.
Yeah.
That's a shame.
So basically the angle was just right for it to scope over the engine deck.
Mm-hmm. That's fine.
Ruining that beautiful paint job of yours.
I know. I don't like shooting my own vehicles.
Okay, what's left?
Right, can't be much left.
You?
Yep.
And then after that, it's all me.
Sweet. All right. More reserve time, I think.
Yeah.
Let's try and bring another Sherman on board, because you got 2 tanks on here, and
I'm nervous. I mean, like, your Firefly on its own can do a lot of damage.
Yep.
But it's getting it to be not the sole target mm-hmm. is going to be your issue.
All right, so roll for reserve.
You get it?
So I've got a Sherman coming in.
You get an idea where you would like it?
Yes. So we're going to bring in one of the M4A4s.
Aye.
And let's have a looky here. There's 2 places I really want the Shermans.
Mm-hmm.
But for now, I think we're going to try and start bringing them in here.
All right, so one there.
And
they roll on down the draw. I do kind of like the fact that the train blocks the 2 draws.
Yeah. It is helping a bit.
You're on at the run or at the move?
I'm going to... I think I'm going to have to run.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely think I'm going to have to run. Because what it will allow me to do is get into a position over here behind the train.
Way back, okay. Yeah, where you're kind of safe-ish.
Yeah, I'm keeping the tanks out of line of sight at the minute.
Mm.
Because in my head, they're bringing themselves up going, we don't know where everything is. We can't talk to the infantry yet. We haven't got a lot of reports, so we're staying in cover as much as possible.
Okay, so for the end of the turn, mm-hmm. I have 3 more orders, right? So, order number 1. I'll actually put down towards the front of the beach here and get this moving.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it's just going to get an advance order, so tape measure. So because it's half track, it's 9. It will go 9 to here.
Okay.
And take its order with it. It will then fire its medium machine gun into here.
Mm-hmm.
Which is going to be 5 dice.
Yep.
Needing 6s. So I'm hopeful. I got 1.
Yep.
So that's another pin on that unit.
It is.
Important. And a 5 to kill a guy. 6. 1
so
dice.
1 dies.
Beautiful.
Which?
My next order. I'm going to put onto the unit inside this.
Yep.
We're going to disembark because you didn't call a mine roll. Did you make a mistake there?
Nope.
Okay. Important. Grab the unit.
Uh-huh.
I think I have everybody here. So let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the guy that's in here is the NCO. Okay. Get you out without breaking anything.
Mm-hmm.
So with a 6-inch move. Ah, no, I have to go 6 inches from the back door, yeah?
Well, it's open topped, so you can jump out from the sides.
All right. Up to there is where I'll get to.
Uh-huh.
And everybody else will just go with you. So I think everybody's going to be in point-blank range for this.
Mm-hmm.
Which should help me, even though you're still in hardcover. So we'll say about there for everybody.
Yep.
Happy enough?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so... I've got light machine gun. Oh, actually, I should have been an extra shot on that medium machine gun.
Yeah.
So, sorry, you'll take that now?
Yeah, take it now.
So, no.
No, okay.
Now, LMG, 5 shots for me.
Mm-hmm.
I then got commander assault rifle.
Yep.
I've then got the other guys, which is 8 men then, becomes 7 men with regular rifles. Everybody has moved.
Mm-hmm.
The only one that doesn't count for is the assault rifle. So that's 4 to start with.
Yep.
Hardcover, mm-hmm. which is 6s. And point blank brings it back by 1.
Yep.
So assault rifles are on 4. Everybody else is on 5.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be 4 hits.
Yeah.
Which is not bad.
Nope.
Into a bunker, but mm-hmm. I suppose. We are right up beside it. So that's a 3rd pin for that unit. And now 5s to kill. One more dice.
Okay.
Hooray. So. Whew. Okay, I took a risk.
You
it
did.
It paid off.
Yep.
So they get their advance order on them. And then I have 1 left. I'm going to go up to the back of the board here and get this unit on the run.
Okay.
Because I think they need to book it, because otherwise they are just going to get mowed down very, very soon.
Mm-hmm.
So that's 12 inches they can run. Still too short of the bunkers. I won't get to shoot this time. But I'm right up in your face.
Mm-hmm.
So you either have to come and fight me or hope that you can mow me down. Or bring something else in that can do the job.
Yep. I remember a Sherman has 2 medium machine guns on it.
I do, but I'm hoping that I may get the first activation next turn, because that is now turn.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm thinking is we'll take a very quick break.
Yep.
Just get everything reset for everybody, and then we'll go on. Let's kick straight into it with me.
Okay.
With me. Where do I want to go?
What do you want to do right now? Hmm?
You see, I've got a few dilemmas here, because my Panther can see across to your Sherman,
mm-hmm.
Firefly. So it's a big threat. I will have to deal with it. Also, I'm within sort of range of all 3 objectives, so I could maybe nab one of those early this turn.
Mm-hmm.
This one I'm not so worried about, because you're on 3 pins.
Yep.
Over here, I am kind of worried about it, because you've got that brain gun carrier there. So I'm going to give these guys an advance order, which I believe will do the job. If I can find advance on the dice. There it is. So 6-inch move brings me up into base contact with the bunker.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not sure if we explained to everybody what our win conditions were here. So do you want to take everybody through that while I move these?
Yep. So again, I did briefly explain it, that the bunkers are the objectives of this game. So at the end of the game, if you've pushed me out of a bunker and taken it, you hold that objective.
Yeah.
Now, if I still have guys in there, you can do a couple of things. We've been talking about the use of satchel charges and, you know, something chucked in through the slit of the bunker.
Yeah.
Which will sort of work a bit like how the minefields have worked. I'll roll a dice.
Aye.
It'll be a 4 up. So 1, 2, or 3, satchel charge goes off, nobody notices it, it goes woof, clears the bunker out, everybody in there is dead.
Yeah.
Because that's how it worked.
Yeah.
4, 5, or 6, they see it, they either chuck it back out and it detonates somewhere out of the way, or these guys get out of the bunker.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're probably going to do it that on a 4, 5, or 6, I get out of the bunker.
Well, how about we do 4 or 5, you get out. On a 6, the satchel charge gets bunged out and you get to keep the bunker.
Okay.
Sound fair?
Yep, that's fine.
All right, so this is a fun game, guys. We are just kind of making it up as we go along sometimes, which is fun to do, you know.
Yeah.
So, John, I am at the bunker.
Yes.
With an advance order.
Yes.
I'm going to throw a satchel charge into your bunker.
Okay. Right, here we go. Right. So he's thrown...
if you have to run out of the bunker,
yep,
and or if you stay in the bunker, I would say D3 pins?
D3 pins.
Okay, because, okay, you know, holy crap, an explosive just came through the door.
But if I throw the satchel charge out the slit on a 6, you take the hit.
Done.
Okay.
Well, I take the pins,
yeah,
not the hit.
Okay.
All right.
Yep.
So on a 4+, see if you stay in there.
A 4.
He stays in.
Stay in.
But you do take D3 pins.
Yep. 3
pins. Lovely.
That puts that unit up to 4.
Yeah. Also, I had a pin on that unit on the other side from last turn.
You did.
Which I forgot about.
Yep.
So I will quickly roll their morale. No.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it's 2d6, and I have to roll under their leadership. They are basic regular guys, so it's 9 or less.
Yep.
On 2. Otherwise, they may have done something else. 9, just about fine.
Mm-hmm.
So they would drop that pin for having passed the order test and be okay where they are.
Grand.
Huh.
So
it's easy to forget these things.
Right, so that's them.
That's them done.
Done. Okay.
And that's that unit pretty badly done.
So we're saying that on the advance order, they can either shoot or they'll throw the satchel charge if they're in base contact.
Yeah. It's you.
Okay.
So I'm feeling quite comfortable now. There's pins on John's side of the table. I'm quite okay with this.
Mm-hmm. Right. I have tons to do and not a lot of time to do it.
Yeah.
Which is a big problem. Right.
Now, I'm assuming you can also throw satchel charges in and reverse it once I'm inside the bunker.
I would say you wouldn't want to do that. We're going to have to close combat it out if you're inside the bunker,
Okay, fair enough.
Because if you throw a satchel charge and we're all in the bunker and we all go, uh-oh, we clear the bunker out of everybody.
Okay.
Right.
Where are you going to go?
I'm just, in my head, it's going, tank battle, tank battle, tank battle, get the armor. It's like,
You do get that sort of a tunnel vision on tanks sometimes, John. Yep. That's kind of why I've left the Panther there, just sitting big and pretty and shiny and, hello, look at me, I'm a Panther, shoot me.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah. You could do that. There are other threats on the board.
There is.
And remember the win conditions.
Yeah. So this Sherman over here behind the train.
Yeah.
He's going to be issued an advance order.
Uh-huh.
Which he's going to trundle
yep.
To here.
Yeah.
Now he's sitting here because he's in great cover from the Panzer IV.
Yep, you're going to get cover.
But he's got 2 MMGs.
Aye, which we mentioned last turn.
Yep. So he's going to open up with the 2 of them onto this infantry squad out here.
MMGs are a base of 5.
Mm-hmm.
So 5. And 5 for you, Mr. Lyons.
Yep.
You have moved.
I've moved.
I'm not going to call cover from that.
No, you're in the open.
Yeah.
So
force.
Let's try it. Good hits.
So at least 1 pin on there.
Yep. So that's 8 hits.
And force to kill. Any exceptionals? Or no, that's on the wounds.
Yeah.
Which we actually didn't do in the bunkers last turn.
No,
I'm
going
to say, you know, you're in a bunker. It's not going to be easy to get the exceptional damage in there. So we'll ignore it inside the bunker if I'm shooting in.
It's dark inside a bunker. It's going to be very hard for you to pick the guy and go, that's the NCO.
Yeah.
Maybe not so hard to pick out the machine gunner. He's the guy killing all my friends. Force to kill.
Yeah.
There's a lot of dead.
That's 6 guys die.
Mm-hmm.
You got 2 possible exceptionals.
Yep.
So do you want to roll those?
I'll roll those. And it's if I get a 6 again?
Yes, yeah, 6 again.
None.
No. So it is just 6 regular guys.
Mm-hmm.
So you're regular, you're regular, you're regular, you're regular, you're regular. And you're a regular. That is, however, a test.
Yeah, because you've lost over 1/2 in 1 round of shooting.
Yes, which is a pain. Mm-hmm. So it's my leadership -1.
Yep.
I'm well outside range of my...
Lieutenant. Yep.
Or lieutenant.
Lieutenant.
Not British.
Well, okay. You can call them lieutenants if you want. Or oberlieutenants.
Nah. Lieutenant, nah. All right, so I'm on 8 or less, or they run away.
Mm-hmm.
5, they don't.
So they actually sit still. I suppose, where do you have to run to?
Yeah, you know the spiders you sometimes see that bury themselves in the sand? I just have images of these guys going, nope. Okay.
All right.
Dice then.
That was effective.
That was very effective.
Mm-hmm.
Me? Or no, it's you.
It's me.
Damn. You infantry section. That squad off.
Yeah, the infantry section in here will open up on them too.
Yeah, so you've got your machine gunner. And you've got 2 guys with rifles.
Yep, so just a regular fire order on these guys.
Yeah, so it's 4 for the machine gun.
4 for the machine gun.
2 regular guys.
Which I have here.
Oh, right, you already have it there?
I have the machine gunners here.
Grant.
Give me the rifle shots if you could, please.
Okay, so 2 white dice for the rifles.
Okay. Let's do this.
Now, here's the interesting thing. You've not moved.
Nope.
I have no cover.
Nope.
And we're in point-blank range.
Yep.
So it's 2s.
Mm-hmm. To hit?
Yeah.
Sweet.
Everybody. Okay, so that's another pin on my unit.
Yep. Everybody's hit.
Yep. 2 more die.
Possible exceptional.
Yep.
No.
No. So 2 more regular guys.
Yep. No, you've lost half again.
So I'm not sure if you test twice in a turn, though. 50-50. Although you killed Gunther and Willy.
Eh.
Tell you what, we'll four up it to see if we need to test again because we're unsure. One, two, three, I don't.
I think it's every time you lose half in a single shot.
We'll do it then. Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm now at my leadership minus two. Mm-hmm. So that's seven or less. See if these two guys... Snake eyes. Insane bravery on the beaches.
Again, where do they have to run to?
No, they've buried themselves down. It's just like, nope, 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 nope. We're safe. And it's me.
Okay.
What did I do? What did I do? What did I do? Well, that unit's pretty badly screwed.
Mm-hmm.
And they may not activate. So I think I need to actually clear up this side of the table. So I'm going to activate... I'll activate my Panzer IV.
Yep.
Is here.
Yep.
I'll give him a fire order. Mm-hmm. So... And shoot.
Mm-hmm.
So you have cover, so it's going to be a 4 for me to hit, yeah?
Yep.
And it's one shot on a heavy anti-tank gun.
Mm-hmm.
Come on. No!
Missed.
Dud round.
Mm-hmm. Buried it into the embankment somewhere.
I don't know, just put it into the boiler of the train.
Yeah.
You.
Yep.
It's you, it's Mr. Me. Lions.
It is. These guys are in a lot of trouble over here.
Mm.
In the center. The carrier is going to get an advance order.
Okay.
He's going to advance and just...
Up to the wall?
Up to the wall.
Yeah.
And then he's going to open fire with the LMG.
Yeah.
Which is four shots.
Four shots. You have moved. So mm-hmm. It's fours. You are within half range.
Yeah.
So, it's fours.
One.
Well, it's a pin on them.
Yeah.
And it's a four to kill. One yep. dies.
One dies.
So, Ulrich.
Ulrich.
At the back.
Mm. Right. Next.
Yep.
Meet you. Okay.
Hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to deal with other threats here. But I think I'm going to have to go down the front of the beach for this one.
Mm-hmm.
So my squad here, not pinned, no problems.
Yep.
They're going to move up and they're going to throw a satchel charge. So it's just an advance order.
Yeah.
Find the advance order. I can never find the advance order. So everybody's got plenty of room to move up to the firing slit. And running through the sand. Oh, what a lovely day at the beach it is, Hans, isn't it?
Mm.
And satchel charge for you.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you want me to roll it or will you?
You roll it.
All right. So, one, two, three, dead.
Mm-hmm.
Four, five, they jump out.
Yep.
Six, you stay in.
Yep.
Three.
Three.
They're dead.
They are. You have cleared out the bunker.
Mm. But I can't advance into it
until
they activate again. And you have another squad right over there just waiting to run in.
Mm-hmm. That is right. So that is my first unit dead.
Mm.
Now.
Oh, wait.
Yep.
There.
So that's my first unit dead.
Yes.
They didn't activate, so the dice comes out of the bag as normal.
Yes.
Now, because we're only running 10 dice per side, that is not being replenished at all. So this is going to... You're going to start to see the decay of what each side can do as we start to lose units.
Well,
although the units are recycling through...
Yes.
The dice are becoming less.
Yeah, well, it's that whole thing of, you know, my advance up the beach will lose momentum.
Yep.
Your reserves are going to run out in the back lines from the area that I'm trying to invade here.
Yep.
So I think that's going to work really nice. But that's one for me.
Yep.
Which I'm quite happy with.
Yep.
Next dice. Make sure and shake it. Make sure and shake it. And hand out the bag. Me.
Okay.
It's me.
Nuts.
It's me.
Try it.
Right. I think I've sussed where your minefield is.
Right.
So, now don't tell me if I'm right.
Okay.
But I'm thinking between this set of fences and this set of fences is where the minefield is. So I'm actually going to activate the squad that's in here,
mm-hmm.
have them jump outside the minefield and advance.
Okay.
I hope. So, advance order onto them. And I will grab my unit, who are way over here. Off screen. Come here, my little beauties.
Uh-huh.
So, my commander will come out. B, peel out and run 6. And we are doing it at the end of the movement. So I hope that I'm out of the minefield there and safe.
Just waiting for you to finish the movement.
Yeah. I'm having to line my guys up because I'm trying to avoid being past the line. Here, let me actually change camera so you can see a little better. So I'm trying to line my guys so that I'm not past this line here, which is where I think Missouri Lions has placed his minefield. Am I correct?
They're safe.
Yes! I figured it out. Okay. So, who do I have in range? Because what these guys are now going to do is, from here, they're going to take a shot. I'll give you soft cover, because I'm going through a fence. So I've got rifle guy, rifle guy, rifle guy, rifle guy, rifle guy, LMG guy, and that's an MG42 guy. I'm going to say no one else can shoot.
Yep.
All right. So, 12 to the back guy. So I'm in my half range for everybody, except for the assault rifle. Okay?
Yep.
So my LMG.
Now assault rifles are, what, 18 inches?
Yes, that got changed. They're 18. So half of the 18 is numbers 9. So he's definitely outside of his half.
Yeah.
All right. But my rifles are in. I've got 5 of those. My LMG is in. I'm getting 5 shots from him. Then I've got 2 from the assault rifle, who is on an additional +1. So, 3 basic. I have moved, goes to 4. You have soft cover, goes to 5.
Yep.
So the it's 5s with the 2 blacks needing 6s.
That is a heck of a good round of shooting. So your LMG just completely...
LMG is on the ball, everybody else not so much.
Yep.
But that's okay. You know, this is fine. That's still 5 shots.
That's what happens when you have a burst fire weapon and there's a unit in front
there.
Of you. Yep.
And those guys are veterans?
No, these guys are the regulars that are following up.
Ah, so these are your reserves.
Yep.
Got it. Alright, so it's 4s to kill.
Oh boy.
2 with a possible exception.
2 with an exceptional.
It is an exceptional. I will take your LMG out of that
there
squad.
Isn't an LMG in that section.
Then it's your NCO.
Okay, NCO's gone.
That could not have went better for me, to be completely honest with you, John.
Yep.
Because now that squad's constantly going to be on -1 for losing the NCO. They've got a pin on them, so that's like -2.
Yep.
So that should hopefully lock them down and give me time to clamber through the firing slit and get into that bunker.
Yep.
And be safe from your Daimler. It's me.
You're getting a lot of initiative early in the game.
But it means you get the big swing back at me.
Yeah.
And even if I'm taking stuff and knocking out here where you don't want to activate it, you still have plenty of reserves to bring in.
Yep.
So I'm going to try up at the other side. This has to be the round where I break those bunkers, you know, make it or break it time. So an advance order for the two guys over here. They've got their -2.
Yep.
To their leadership, they are regular. So it's 7 or less on 2. Oh, double 6. That's a foobar.
Ah. But they can only shoot each other.
Hans, it's all the way too long.
Okay.
So I will roll my foobar. 3.
It's a 3.
Which is panic. The unit executes a run order and must move as fast as possible away from the closest visible enemy unit. If no enemy is visible, or if the unit can no longer move for some reason, it goes down instead. Well, over here, that's a very close enemy unit.
It has to run as far away from that as possible.
Yeah, so
which is back into the sea.
You have pushed the Germans back into the sea once, John. The 12 inches brings them right back to there.
Yep.
Which is actually off camera. They're right in here now.
They're over there. This Sherman's going to come in at the advance, I'd say. So he's going to come in 9 inches.
Yeah.
Which brings him up level to the back of the carrier. I'm going to nudge these trees out of the way because he's
a tank. Yeah, that's fine. Trust me, tree versus tank, tank wins.
Yep.
Especially with the Collins hedgerow cutter on there.
Yeah. So this Sherman has arrived and went, there's a lot of infantry over there.
Yeah.
Let's take it slow and open fire on them.
Okay. So you're getting your 2 medium machine guns opening up again.
Yep.
which is 5 shots apiece, so there's an additional 3.
Hang on. 2, 3, 4...
5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay.
All right, so which unit are you shooting at?
It's going to be the guys that just made it out of the minefield. They're the best target, yeah.
Okay, that's fine.
I am shooting through
a lot of stuff,
and this friendly unit is sort of maybe blocking my...
I'm just going to call soft cover on it.
Yeah, all right.
All right, so you've moved soft cover. That means you need fives.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Here we go.
Well, there's at least a pin there.
2 hits.
Yep, so I'll put the pin onto this unit as well, which is fine.
Okay. Move the dice out of the way here. Get out of the way, and then 2 wounds.
Yeah, leading 4s. 2 kills?
Possible, exceptional.
Okay.
Because we have a 6 here.
Yeah, gun ahead. It's not exceptional.
No, so 2 dead.
I'll just take 2 regular guys from the front here.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll do. So... Mayor, and who was the other? Siegfried.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Right, so that Sherman's done a wee bit of damage, that's fine.
Mm-hmm. It's me.
You.
Alright. Time for the big cat to play.
Mm-hmm.
So, as you can see on the side of the table, I'm gonna turn. I will advance and then fire to get a better line on it.
Mm-hmm.
Because otherwise this is going to be a nigh impossible shot.
Yep.
So I don't need to advance very far. I'll just trundle up to about here.
Yep.
Which will give me, I think, a reasonably clear shot, John. Would you say you have cover there or not?
I'd say there's a little bit of intervening cover.
Okay.
I'd say there wouldn't
so
be much.
We'll call it soft.
Yep.
So I've moved. Soft cover. 5. Skadoosh. No.
Miss.
Damn. But I am set up for next turn.
Yep.
That's fine. Fine.
Right. Dice.
Yep. Next dice. Keep me on track, y'all.
Yeah, yeah.
It's you.
Firefly needs to return fire.
without moving.
He
well,
does.
You wouldn't have had to move anyway.
No. So he will be issued a fire order.
Uh-huh.
You have moved nicely onto your side armor for me.
Don't forget, you have to be past the front, does it not? Or is it on a 45 degree angle?
It's 45 degrees, I think.
Oh, blast. Okay.
So you've revealed your side armor nicely to me.
Okay, so you haven't moved.
Yep.
You're within half range.
Yep.
Any cover?
My veterancy's regular as well, don't forget.
Yep.
So I'm under half range and haven't moved. Mm. And you're pretty exposed from my position.
Fair enough.
If you'd stayed back, you'd have got cover with the half track being there.
Yeah, that's okay. So it's just a flat 3?
Flat 3.
2.
Really?
Of all the things. Munitions factory people, do your job better.
You've been sat there, you're waking up, you see it there, why are you missing? Clearly Joe Atkins is not in my tank.
Well, someone's about to wake up, here you go.
Yep. Right. The temptation to form a little tank battle over here is too much.
Yeah.
Whereas your
tanks could be very useful for, you know, just clearing down the infantry
that's
down this end of the table.
I'm going to try and bring in the other Sherman,
okay,
the last
one. It's on a 3 up.
Mm-hmm.
A 2.
No. Okay.
So engine problems.
It's now away for that turn.
Yep.
Great. Okay.
Next dice.
Yep.
Me.
You again.
So what I really need to do
mm-hmm.
is down this side of the table I need to focus on, because this is where I'm going to score my first victory point.
So yep.
I'm going to activate this. He's not going to move. He's just going to fire, because I'm hoping by not moving, I don't have to worry about the minefields, yeah?
Well, if he's not moving,
yeah.
You're not rolling over anything.
Yeah. So this is just going to fire its MG at them, because if I remember right, in the new bolt action second edition, transports can fire their weapons.
Yeah.
Excellent. So that'll be 6 shots at that unit. I will go and give you soft cover.
Mm-hmm.
It's a medium machine gun, so 36, so half of 36... 18.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just see if I'm in the half range. I am.
Yep.
Which is fine. So it's going to be force. So I'm just hoping I can pin them down, keep you out of that bunker long enough for me to get in.
Yep.
A miss and a miss. So that's 4 hits.
Mm-hmm.
And a second pin onto them.
Yep.
which is perfect for me. And then they're regular force to kill. So two more die, yep. No exceptionals.
That's half unit loss, so that's a test.
Yep. And had they lost their NCO?
Yes, because you picked them off.
Yes, I did. So they're actually at -3 leadership.
Yeah.
Which is 6 or less on 2. Challenge.
No, 7. They failed.
They run away.
And they do.
Back to Blighty. Oh, wait. We're already there.
We're already there, so we're just going home.
Yeah.
For a little bit.
I say, Jeffrey, it's a bit rough out today. Shall we head home for some tea and crumpets? Well, boy, I'd say that would be a very spiffing idea. These Yemen fellows seem a little bit rough for us today.
Sorry, I couldn't resist. Okay, dice.
Yep, go for it.
Oh, actually.
What?
Had they activated it? No, they hadn't.
No, they hadn't, so I've lost the dice again.
Yes.
Painful. Excellent. Oops.
It's me.
Yep.
Okay, that side is pretty much sewn up. I'm quite happy with that.
Yep.
I think where I need to be looking now is I need to take a risk, mm-hmm. I think. Or actually, no, I don't. There's a unit still inside this, yeah?
Yep.
So, I have a light anti-tank gun
yep.
in this.
Yep.
So, it's just going to sit where it is,
mm-hmm.
take a fire order, and shoot that.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
So,
single shot.
Single shot, definitely within half range. Am I within point blank, I wonder?
Point blank of an anti-tank gun?
Well, just a rule that's in the game, point blank.
Yeah.
I think it's like 6 inches, isn't it? So from the barrel, no, I'm out.
You're right. So it's still within half, but...
Yeah. So it's just flat 3, I would say, from where we're at.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, like, it's a vehicle. It's easily seen from where it is.
Still sitting behind a wall.
Okay, do you want to call it a 4?
Carrier's a small vehicle.
Okay, we'll call it a 4. A 1.
Well, you were...
Wouldn't have mattered anyway.
Wouldn't have mattered. It doesn't matter. Gun failed to fire. They took the round out and exploded in their face.
No, the... The guy who's in there, you know, he may have had a Russian making that round for him.
No, do you know what? The sand has got into the gun.
Ah.
We can't get the round actually into the breech. There you go.
Okay, dice.
Yep.
You.
Okay.
Okay, we're coming down to the last couple of activations here.
Mm-hmm. Right, I still have one carrier I can bring forward.
Yeah, I think you may need to.
Yep, I really do. So I'm going to try and bring him on. So 3+.
Uh-huh. Yep, yes, he's in.
Finally, okay.
Which is fine.
Carrier with a 5-man unit.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm taking this side of the beach as a loss. If the vehicles can do anything, great. If they can't, they're just going to annoy you over there.
Yeah.
So the infantry needs to be getting up to positions where I can really help. So this carrier is going to come in at a run from back here.
Uh-huh.
His run is what tracked vehicle is on the run.
Tracked vehicle on the run. So it's standard 9,
yep.
Run 18.
Run 18.
It's the vehicles that are 12, 24.
Yep, okay. So.
Oh, actually, that... A plan appears. So go ahead, John.
I don't like it when you do that.
I saw a thing. I may try and do a thing. We'll see if that thing works.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we're not doing that.
Okay, go ahead.
So the carrier's going to come in at a run and park himself up behind
mm-hmm.
the train.
Okay.
That was at a run, so...
Yep.
That's him done.
Okay.
There can't be much left.
We both have one each after this one, so it's on me.
Yep.
And I'm going to see if my plan, my thought of a plan, perhaps my brain fart, works.
Mm.
Okay?
Okay.
So... this here, I'm going to give an advance order.
Mm-hmm.
I know I'm in a minefield.
Yep.
But we'll see what happens. So, it's going to be regular advance order. Mm-hmm. So he's got 12 inches to move.
Yep.
So, from there, 12 inches up to here. Stop there. Am I still in the minefield?
Mine test.
Okay. Now, one thing I will say, John. Minefields, because I'm already in the minefield, it's kind of like doubling up the chances that I'm going to hit one.
Yep.
So do you want to change the number to something else for what I need to roll here?
Let's say from moving from static to continue through a minefield to get out of it, let's roll a 5 or a 6.
5 or a 6.
This time, yeah.
Okay, that sounds fair. A 1.
A 1. Oh, he's good.
This guy is headed for Monaco. Okay, now, from where he is,
uh-huh.
The heavy anti-tank gun.
Yes. The carrier has just popped up there. Yep.
So, heavy anti-tank gun is 12 to 72. So there actually is a minimum range. Oh, no, that's mortar.
That's mortar.
Silly me. Heavy anti-tank gun, 72. One shot. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
I've moved.
Yep.
You're within half range.
Yep.
No half cover.
Nope.
So it's a 4.
Mm-hmm.
He gets a 2.
Yeah.
Oh!
So he rolled up and missed.
He rolled up. Dodging mines. Everybody's panicking. Don't hit the mines. And fire. You missed. You idiot. You missed. But, oh well. So, 2 dice left.
Yep.
It's you.
It is.
Will you be doing something sneakily?
Yes. I think.
Okay.
I'm not sure. Both, all 3 Shermans currently have activated. The other one can't.
Mm-hmm.
You're a light vehicle. But so is that, and so is that. I'm going to have to start switching my focus.
Yeah.
So the vehicles that are over here are going to have to start moving up.
He already tried to activate this turn, so yeah.
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 So the Daimler is going to get an advance order.
Okay. Now this is your last activation for the turn, just to be sure you know it.
Yeah. He's a wheeled vehicle, so he's got a fair decent move on him.
12 base at the run, 24.
Yep. So the 12 gets him to there.
I assume staying out of the minefield.
Yep. Which puts him... Actually, if I do that, and then I'll just guarantee that I'm not making fun of my own rule. Yeah. So he should be gaining cover from the Lux if it decides to fire.
Yep.
But he's got you on the back.
Yep.
On this armored car. So he's been given the advance order.
Yep.
He's a light anti-tank gun.
Yep.
So let's see what we can do now.
48-inch range.
Mm-hmm.
So you're definitely within 24. One shot. You've moved. I have no cover, so it's a 4+.
Mm-hmm. Here we go.
It hits.
Okay.
Okay. So the light anti-tank gun has a pen value of 4.
Mm-hmm.
I am a... What I count as an armored car, yeah?
Yep.
That's a 7.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a 3 for superficial.
Yep.
4 for actual damage. I'm not sure how the facing works.
Yeah.
It doesn't say here.
I'm not sure if vehicle facing particularly matters anyway.
Yeah. Well, if it makes a difference by 1, we'll have a closer look at it.
Yeah. Right. Here we go.
So
damage. Up. 3.
3. So that'll be a superficial.
Right. So superficial damage then.
Yeah.
So I have to now roll on that chart.
Roll on the chart. Now, damage results. Yeah. Here we go. Okay, so superficial, armored vehicles only. Will the car count as an armored vehicle?
Yeah, it's an armored vehicle.
Right. D6 minus 3.
Okay. 1. Nothing.
So, crew stunned.
Yep.
Add 1 additional pin marker to the vehicle and place a down or order die next to the vehicle or change its current order dice to down to show that it is halted and cannot take further action that turn. If that vehicle has 1 or more turrets... Also roll for turret jam.
Right. So you've taken a pin marker because I hit you.
Yep.
You've taken another pin marker because I've stunned you.
Yes. So, here. There we go.
This is the first vehicle that's actually had a proper hit on it, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing else has done that yet.
All right.
Uh-huh.
I think there's 1 dice left. Yes, me. Yep.
Yours.
What do I want? What do I want and where? What is not activated? See, I can't do anything with that. What I can do, I have 1 more vehicle off the table that I'm going to roll for.
Okay.
So, it's going to be a 3+.
Yep.
6, so it comes in. Let me grab it.
You have a martyr.
So, what the martyr is going to do, if I can get the angle right on this, I'm going to move my book out of the way. In fact, John, take my book, hold it just for a second until I get this on the table.
All right.
So, it's just going to trundle up 9 inches, and I'm going to do it right the way across here, because if I trundle on, like, here at 9, I can get shot into the butt of your Firefly, just right between the train cars.
Very difficult shot, but yeah.
Well, I've moved, you've got heavy cover, so I'm going to call it a 6, alright? It's 1 shot on a heavy anti-tank gun.
Yep.
A three. So it misses.
Okay.
Into the boxcar. You know, hit some food packages or something.
Yep.
So, yep. I'll take that back.
Okay.
Okay, so that'll be turn end.
Mm-hmm.
No victory conditions met just yet, so I think we'll take another quick break, get everything tidied up, and ready for the next round. So we'll be right back. John, I'm going to let you draw the dice out of the bag this round.
Yep.
Because I think it's a little unfair. I want to keep things impartial. So you get that. Don't look in the bag. Does it feel like one of... Oh, it's one of mine.
Go ahead. Yeah. See what you can do.
Okay. So I think what I need to do to kick off is get my guys into that bunker down the front here. Because I think... If I can take this and get in here, I'm on the pig's back, I'm laughing.
Yeah.
So, all my guys will just quietly clamber through and take up position inside. Now, I assume I won't be firing out of this anytime soon.
No.
Quite simply for the fact, because then I'm firing back down the beach, and my own guys need to come back up the beach.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Yep.
So, that'll do me.
Okay. So, over to... Me again, yep, and okay. You again.
Me again. It's me again. Oh, that unit needs to take its two pins with it.
Yep.
Other than that, I think we're pretty okay.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to go for... I'm going to keep up the pressure. I'm going to go for the middle here.
Yep.
And I'm going to pop another satchel charge in.
Right.
So, a fire order, mm-hmm. I would assume.
Well, that's just... We know what's happening now anyway, so...
Yep. Do I roll it or will I?
You go ahead, you're rolling into it, so...
Alright, so 1, 2, 3 dead, 4, 5 alive but jumping out.
Yeah.
6, they're fine and still in.
Mm-hmm. 6.
Alive and still in.
You take D3 pins because we chucked the thing back out again.
Yeah, do you want to roll that?
Yes, I do. 2.
Okay. So that becomes a 1, but yep. I forgot, I have an order test to make because mm-hmm. they have a pin on them.
Yeah.
So, leadership minus 1, they are regular, so 8 or less, to see if I can even throw the satchel chart.
No.
I do not.
So you failed.
I would have failed, and they would go down.
Yep, they went to the ground instead.
I'm actually kind of okay with this.
Yeah, I can
because
I can see
it means that I don't get that D3 pin.
Yeah. Because that never happened.
If you forget stuff, just quickly rewind, do it.
Yep. You. Me. No, I need this section back up and running.
Yep, you going to go for a rally?
I think we're going to have to take a rally, yeah. So I'm going to issue the rally order.
Mm-hmm.
I'll then need to make a leadership minus 4.
Ah, but I think rally has changed, if I remember.
Has it?
Rally, no move or fire, but mm-hmm. loses D6 plus 1 pin markers.
Oh, so it's just a thing I can do now.
I believe so. I'm 90% sure of this. If I'm wrong, feel free to hang me in the comments, but D6 plus 1 off.
Okay. So 3.
So that satchel charge that I put in there that you dodged out of the way of, never happened.
No, it didn't, thankfully. Take those over there.
Yeah.
Great. Bag.
Yeah. Me again.
Right. Mr. Firefly requires...
Oh dear.
Requires his boomstick to go. So we're going to issue a fire order again onto the Firefly.
Uh-huh. You're sitting still.
Still sitting still.
Now, I will say this time... You have a brain gun carrier in the way.
Mm-hmm.
So I will claim cover off that.
Okay.
So that'll be a 4, yeah?
A 4.
No.
3.
Ah. That's unfortunate.
Nuts.
All right. Just imagine your commander sitting there going, what's that bloody idiot doing in my line of fire? Hell with it. Launch it anyway.
Yeah.
You. It is moi.
Are you going to do the return stroke?
No. Because there's something a little more dangerous nearby,
mm-hmm.
which is up in the top corner here, I have my guy,
mm-hmm.
you have your guy,
mm-hmm.
so this is going to move.
Right.
Or is it? No, it's just going to sit still and take the 4-up shot at you.
Okay.
So, fire order. Fire. Single shot on a 4
mm-hmm.
onto the front of your tank.
Right.
It hits.
5. Okay.
Beautiful. Okay, weapons chart, because you're on a medium hull.
Yep.
Which is a 9.
And you're a heavy anti-tank gun.
Which is a 6.
Yep.
So it's a 3 plus to damage.
Yep. 2.
That'll be a 2. Damn it.
Unfortunate.
So actually, On the heavy anti-tank gun, that brings me to 8, but you're 9 flat, yeah. So it would have been the 3 to actually do a superficial.
Yeah, 3 to superficial, 4 to penetrate.
So, choo!
Yeah.
Missed. Draw.
Draw again, yep. Me.
It is you.
I will make the return stroke then this time.
Okay.
And this Sherman will return fire onto the Panzer IV.
Okay.
So, we've had enough of that damn thing firing at us on our own country. We're going to return, goddammit, we're going to kill things.
That sounded very American. I'm sorry, comment below. Is it just me or did that sound very American? I think what you mean to say is, those lads over there have just shot at us. I believe it's time to return fire, my dear boy.
Well, these are Irish guards.
Oh, hang on. Then it's something completely different. These, oi! Yeah. Those seeing you next Tuesday just shot at us.
You see those boys over there, lad? Aye. See them? They fired at us. They certainly did. And it didn't go through the armor. No, it didn't go through the armor at all. No, Jimmy, no, it didn't do that. So what do you want to do in return then, in wee lad? And he's like, right then, Jimmy, we're going to have to just put another one through the front of him, aren't we? Aye. Just you bring her forward a wee bit and we'll open fire on him, aye? Aye, well...
You went a wee bit country there. Beautiful. Alright, so you're shooting at me. You haven't moved. I'm nowhere near that wall, so I'm not going to claim cover. So it's just a straight up 3.
Okay.
Onto my Panzer 4.
It's it a hits. 5. So we've hit him.
Yes. So you have a medium anti-tank gun.
Yes.
Which is 5.
Mm-hmm.
I am on a medium hull, so that's 9.
Yep.
So it's 4 for superficial.
And 5 to get through.
Yeah.
No. What is with us rolling terribly?
I say, Hans, they just returned fire at us.
Jimmy, you missed. Jimmy, I'm sorry, but you just didn't. You're not cutting it today, boy.
Oh, Jesus, boy, I need to put you back on the tractor.
You're better on a farm than you're in a tank, boy. Yeah, get out of this thing because you're absolutely no use to me. Boys, crank her up.
Right, let's get this Sherman advancing.
Aye.
So we'll give him the advance order, and we'll get you rolling straight through this fence, because the fences don't matter.
Yeah.
And crunch through that, and up to here.
Uh-huh.
Then I'm going to swing round and target the Lux.
Okay. Oh! Lux!
I know he hasn't done anything.
He's teeny-weeny and cutesy.
But he has the potential to do things.
Yeah, and it is a dice out of the bag.
It is a dice out of the bag, and that is what I really need right now. So, on his advance order, he is then going to take a shot. So he's moved. You are... what's our cover like? We're shooting through intervening stuff over here, so I'll...
I'd call it light.
Yeah, so that's fine.
Moved, light cover, let's say 5.
5s, okay. Let's try it. We hit.
Oh! No!
So it's a light tank.
It is, so it's only an 8, and you're firing a medium gun, which is 5. 3 for superficial, 4 for penetration.
Yep, we roll a
Don't
2
Don't blow
again.
Up the Lux.
2. We rolled a 2 again.
Mickey, are you loading that marshmallow shells again, son?
Shermans, man. Shermans. You're beautiful to look at, but you just live up to the history.
Right, well, draw.
Right, next one.
It is
you.
I.
It is you now. So it the Lux I. needs to do something because he's now in a panicky position.
No. He will be very German, very stoic.
Really?
Sit there.
Really?
And instead, the martyr will activate.
Okay.
So I will give him an advance order.
Mm-hmm.
And we will get you rolling up the beach, my good son. So I think I'll not roll all the way onto the beach. I'll roll to about here. Because I'm hoping I'm still outside your minefield doing that. Am I?
Your tracks are touching the sand.
But would you do it right at the waterline?
Yeah.
Okay, then I have to roll.
Mine check.
Check.
I didn't tell you. Yeah, that's what I'm going to be doing from now. Mind check. 3. You're okay. Yep.
I do believe the Irish Guard maybe half-assed the laying of this minefield.
Maybe they didn't lay it.
All right, well, it's going to be a fire onto the Sherman from here.
Mm-hmm.
You're in front of a fence, so I will give you light if you want it.
It's a heavy anti-tank gun. I don't think a wooden fence is really going to stop
that's,
it.
Okay.
I think 4. Yeah, I think with the power of the guns that we're playing with here, a right. wooden fence won't mind.
This is very much a common sense game we're playing right now. So what I'm on about is this real fence that's right in front of the Sherman. It's blocking me seeing it properly, but John's saying, oh, shell punch right through that.
The Sherman is 11 feet high.
Okay.
The martyr crew are going to be looking at it going, that is definitely a tank.
Okay. So it's on a 4.
Right, go for it.
6.
I gave him this one.
Well, that would have been 1 anyway.
Yeah.
On a 6. Okay, so it's your medium hull of 9 mm-hmm. to my heavy anti-tank gun of 6.
Yep.
So 3 for superficial.
Okay.
Come on. Kill it.
3.
Superficial.
Superficial is so good for you.
You will take a pin for it.
Yes.
I'll give you that.
Mm-hmm.
And I will roll minus 3 on the damage chart. It's a 3, so it's just crew stunned, so yep. It's just another pin.
Mm-hmm. I'll take an additional pin.
Yes.
I've already activated, so it doesn't really give any sort of other negatives, I don't think.
It does change your order to a down, but a vehicle is never affected by down.
No, it's not. That's fine. Right, next.
Yeah.
Me. There's one more tank to come on, so I'm going to roll for it.
All right.
So this will be the other Sherman at a 3+.
It'll still be a 3 now, because everybody's awake.
No! It's me rolling 2s!
Ah! A couple of different dice.
Ah! Give me those 2. So, this tank again is down, so... Great. Let's try
Where's
again.
Our young Jimmy?
Me again?
Can't make him brekkie.
All right.
Okay.
The Daimler is going to activate and take a pop okay. at the martyr.
Yep.
So
okay.
He's going to issue a fire order. It's a light anti-tank
from
gun.
Here.
Yep. It's a light anti-tank gun against a very light vehicle. So
yeah.
Set his fire order dice down.
So the martyr, does it count as a light hull? I'm guessing.
Yeah, he's light and open topped.
Oh,
so,
lovely.
I mean, if he was open topped and I was HEing him, it would be in trouble. Yeah.
All right. Well, you're not moving.
No.
I'll give you a light just because there's so much in the way.
Yeah, there is. That's fine. Here we go. 5, we hit him.
Okay.
Light anti tank gun against.
Light hull?
Probably a light hull.
So it's 8 versus plus 4, so it's a 4 for superficial.
Yep.
5. That's a penetrate.
So we've got through him.
All right.
Whoosh.
So, just flat as you want.
Let's go for it.
But
what?
Open top, hit. Oh no, it's hit by indirect.
Yeah, when it's hit by indirect, which is not this.
Yeah, so far away.
2.
2. So that is immobilized.
Uh huh.
So that's going to suck.
He may as well have hit a 9.
Part of the vehicle tracks or wheels are blown apart. Add 1 additional pin marker to the vehicle. The vehicle cannot move for the rest of the game.
So you've taken 2 pins.
2 pins, yes. Mm-hmm. 2 pins. Boom and boom. Don't really mind because he's already went for this turn.
Yep.
Ah, it is I. Hmm. Right. I'm going to do something very silly here.
Okay.
All right?
Yep.
So, this unit that just jumped out.
Mm-hmm.
I think the guys have actually got a little spaced out here, but should be okay. So these lads are going to jump back into this.
Okay.
All right, so I'll pop him back in there.
You could put them in the other half track.
No. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I lost one, didn't I? Which is why I have a pin on me.
Yeah.
So I need to test for this. So, 9 or less. They're fine.
Mm-hmm.
And they drop the pin. So that unit, he should be in here.
Yep.
That pin goes away. So I'll put these guys down on the beach here in a second if you want to draw your next.
Right.
So, they're already in there with their order done.
Your dice is next too.
Perfect. Just what I wanted.
Uh-huh. So you're mounting them up and then you're moving the half track.
Pretty much. And the half track is going to get a run order.
Okay.
So I assume I will take 2 tests.
I'm going
because I'm being...
You're being reckless here, so...
Yeah. So, the run order. I didn't expect to try and run through a minefield today, but okay. So run order on here. Base move of 9, max move of 18.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to make first 6 to here.
And then mine test?
I'll mine test to there, because that's where I'm going to make my first turn.
Mm-hmm.
So on a 6, 5.
5 or 6?
5 or 6.
Well, if you know, at the end of your next move, it's a 5 or 6, because if you're coming out of here,
aye.
You're coming out of the sandy area. So 5, that was close.
I've used 6, so I have 12 left.
Yep.
So he's going to go up to here.
And do your final.
And do my final. Be on a 5 or a 6.
5 or 6.
Ah,
boom!
Right, so how did we say that was going to work for a vehicle?
It's immediately immobilized.
Okay, is that all?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's. I think that was the fairest way we came up with it, because we didn't want the vehicle to... I don't really want mines to just wipe a vehicle out.
Yeah.
Want it to be annoying. to the player rather than just outright destroyed.
That's okay, because next turn my guys can bail out and possibly do something from where they're at.
Yep. All right, next turn.
Yeah.
You again.
So I need to do something clever.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of that, I'm going to activate the Panther.
So instead of doing something clever, you're going to move a tank.
No, the Panther's just going to sit and shoot and take a shot at the Firefly.
Okay.
So you have your light cover.
Yep,
so
same as before. Yep.
But I think if I do it enough, it'll be fine.
Yep.
A one.
So you...
Nice gods.
Where'd that go?
Have a goddamn high velocity. I can hear it whistling.
Me. Yeah. It's about time I started utilizing my rolling reserves as well. So I'm going to try and bring back one of the...
Excuse me?
I'm going to roll up one of the veterans.
Yeah.
Because we lost one, so I'm going to bring him back.
Right. But because he's comes back camp now, it's regular guys.
Yeah, it comes back as regular. So these are the guys filling in the holes in the line. So everybody that comes back is regular.
Yeah.
So on a 3.
Yeah.
Which they do.
Uh-huh.
That's great. We now have an infantry squad coming in at the run.
Aye, okay.
So that'll be
12 inches 12. Off.
3, 5. There we go. Uh-huh. They're going to come in here, I think. And we're going to use them to shore up the middle area here.
Aye. See, that's what I was trying to do. I was trying to get a unit across there.
Yeah.
To try and, you know, shore up my own lines, because it's looking a little dicey there for me at the minute.
Great. So they're in at a run. Mm. There it is. Okay. Next. So,
5-man unit.
Yep.
What have we got?
You.
Ah. Okay. Yeah, you know what? I don't like the idea that you actually have, you know, 3 squads now converging on here, so I'm just going to activate this. It's going to sit and shoot at that.
Mm-hmm.
So, fire order. Where is the... So, light anti-tank gun into that.
Mm-hmm.
We said you have light cover.
Yep.
So, it's a 4. It hits.
It hits, yep.
So, the Bren gun carriers, what are they classed as?
They are carriers. They are an armored vehicle.
All right, so 7.
Yep.
To my light anti-tank, a 4. So, I need a 3 for a...
Superficial,
yeah.
2.
Come on!
Our damage rolls are terrible.
Yeah. You'd think these dice were loaded, but we're rolling the same ones.
Yeah. All right, you again.
Okay, it's me again.
It's one of each after that.
All right, so I'm going to take a risk.
Mm-hmm.
My guys who are up here at the top are going to try and advance.
They have the loinant with them now, so
yep.
He can use his morale to remove a pin.
And actually, I'm going to have them run.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, he will remove one of the pins.
Yep.
So they're rolling on an 8 or less.
Mm-hmm.
Here's hoping. Okay, they like it.
Yep.
So this goes away, and they get to run 12 inches. I'm going to run them right up the back of the field here.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm out of the arc of fire, I think.
Yep.
Of your machine gun. So you'll only get 2 rifle shots at me.
True. True. So
trying to be clever.
Yep.
Trying to be clever. Because even 2 guys with a satchel charge could clear that.
This is your last activation.
My last activation. What do I have left that's not gone? I've got that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to just activate the Lux.
Okay.
So he's just going to sit where he's at.
Mm-hmm.
Going to get a fire order. Turret's going to go... And shoot the Daimler.
Okay.
With the autocannon.
Yep.
So, light autocannon, 2 shots, and it's got a +2 pen.
Mm-hmm.
So I can damage it. You have light cover, so it's 4s.
Yep.
So 1 hits.
1 hit.
And your armor...
Light auto.
7.
Yep.
So I need a 5 or better. Worth a try. Oh, come on.
Yeah, fair enough.
That's just... Ugh.
That wasn't going to be a shot that would be particularly good anyway.
Yeah, but it was worth a try.
It was worth a try.
What a random pin marker.
That's the important thing. So I have 1 activation left.
Yeah.
I'm going to run for some reserves again.
Okay.
Because I have more... Actually, I have 1 off the field and 2 on the field that I could just
Yeah, you could just activate one of the ones that's on the field, have it drive up, ready for next turn.
Yeah, I could do that. Problem is, there's not a lot of infantry over here at the minute for me to worry about.
Where you really need to worry about it are in two critical locations, because in here I've got a reasonably undamaged squad ready just to throw another satchel charge in. Next turn, up the back, I've got another two-man squad who are still hanging around like a bad smell, who are now a small team, which are even harder for you to hit.
Yep. Right, what I'm going to do then is the section in here is going to get out, and they're going to do an advance order, and they're going to lay down some fire on these guys.
Okay.
So they're just a normal, regular troop.
Okay. Any light support weapon or anything in there?
Just a submachine gun.
Okay. And so I assume he's going to the front?
Submachine gun and four rifles.
Okay.
So they were issued with an advance.
Yep. And fork.
Yep.
Submachine gun is in blue, and I think he's in point blank.
They're pretty close. So
let's measure this out. So, yeah, he's within his half range, which is point blank.
Mm-hmm.
So for him, moved, plus one.
Yep.
Point blank, minus one. So he's on three, the others are on fours.
Yep.
Well, he didn't need the three anyway.
He clearly didn't need the three.
He's had quite enough of my tomfoolery.
Yes.
So that's four hits. That'll be a pin.
Yep. And then it's fours to wound.
Yes, because they're regulars.
Yep. That's one.
One. And not exceptional, yeah?
No.
So just, there's this. Volker at the back has died.
Yep.
Unfortunate.
Poor fella.
Yeah.
And that is
turn.
That is turn.
Where would you like to go first, Mr. Lyons? Where is the most critical point on the battlefield for you?
Anywhere but here.
Well, let's be honest. The battle has shifted. Down the bottom there, I think I've got reasonably well sewn up. You're not going to get me out of there anytime soon.
No, I can't use the vehicles down there to get that objective now anyway.
Yeah.
And it's not worth running piecemeal into it.
Yeah, exactly. Further up the table here, in here, I think I have a decent chance if I can get to go soon.
Yep.
Up there at the very top, I think is going to be a little bit more risky for me, just in that last little bunker.
Yeah.
So it could go either way at the minute.
The veterans have held out pretty well, considering.
Yeah.
Like, I still have two sections of them up and running.
Yeah, well, the one thing I'll say is I'm actually very surprised that my own guys have held up so well, because normally on a beach landing, I would expect to see much more death, you know, not even getting off the beach.
But then you got the jump on the British force in this scenario.
True.
If I was fully deployed with everything, it would have been a lot more difficult.
Yeah, there would have been a hell of a killing zone, but I think that makes for a good, interesting scenario, the way we've done this.
Yeah. Right then.
Yeah.
Let me see here as my first action. This Daimler is going to have to do something a bit ridiculous soon, I think.
Right.
He needs to get into a better fire position. I'm not worried about the half track anymore. I'm not worried about the looks or the martyr.
So we are back down here for your Daimler.
Yeah.
Okay. So what are you thinking with him?
I'll come back to him, actually.
Okay.
I think there's more critical things going on right now.
Hmm.
Namely, the Firefly taking another pop at the Panther.
Okay.
So he will issue himself a fire order.
So there to there.
Yep.
Not moved. I will say still cover because you've got stuff in the way.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a four.
It's still fours. Two. Oh, come on.
Unfortunate.
Come on. Oh. Right. This marksmanship's getting ridiculous.
You again?
I wish you could take another shot now.
Well, then we'd be playing Antares where you get the mod 2 stuff.
Yeah, true. Let's see, that's...
Although, I did enjoy when we got to play that demo game of Antares.
Yeah, that was
very nice. That little starter scenario was really fun.
Mm-hmm. Right. The Sherman over here...
Okay, so right at the back.
He's going to be given an advance order.
Uh-huh.
Which is going to bring him...
Ooh, you're coming another way.
I am. He's going to turn himself around, and he's going to come to here. And he's going to engage this armored car.
Okay.
With the pack 40 on it.
Yeah, yeah. So you've moved. I have no cover.
Mm-hmm.
I'm immobilized.
Yep.
So I wouldn't have cover anyway.
Nope. Here we go.
Four.
Four.
You hit?
Hit. Okay.
Okay, so medium anti-tank gun to light hull.
Yep.
So...
It's an armored vehicle.
So, yep, so seven.
Yep.
Two, five.
Yep.
So it's a two for superficial. You should do something here.
4.
So that's through, but it's 2 above, which is more important, I think, because I think 2 above is massive damage. Roll 2 results, see above, because I think the massive damage is if you roll 2 over what you need.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I remember anyway. If I'm wrong, again, hang me in the comments. So you get 2 rolls.
Yeah. Are you reading the rule again just to make sure?
Yeah, roll 2 results.
Okay.
So just do it.
Oh. 5 and a 3. Mm. And I pick.
I think both stand.
Both stand, so it's destroyed.
It is knocked out.
Yep.
So that hadn't activated, so I will lose a die.
Yep. My first.
Do you remember momentum starting to slow down a little bit?
Yep.
This game goes much longer.
So you can take those pins away.
Yep. Hmm. Okay.
Right. Next activation then.
Yeah. Well, I'll plop him onto his side here.
Yep.
Just because that'll denote it a little better.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry about the paintwork. Me.
Mm-hmm.
It's me. And you know what? This squad in the middle is pretty okay.
Mm-hmm.
This squad up here is in danger. So they're going to move
and
throw their charge. And I think, oh, actually, one pin on them. So I will need to roll for that.
You will.
So it's -1 because I haven't lost the NCO yet.
Wow.
Oh,
9.
9.
So they failed?
Yeah, they do, and they stay right where they were.
Yep.
So I will quickly move them back.
So they go down.
They go down. Oof.
Mm-hmm.
It was a risk, but it was one that I knew I had to take, because I don't expect them to survive for much longer.
Yeah, exactly.
So, hand in the bag.
Mm-hmm.
It is you.
Yes. Right.
The odds are not in my favor here.
They're not. Time for me to try for reserves again.
Okay.
I'm gonna use a black dice this time.
Okay, use a black dice.
They seem to be rolling better. We're gonna try and get my final Sherman on the field.
Alright.
So
dun 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 dun.
Yep.
Yep.
He's arrived.
He turns up. Okay.
Finally. Hit
him. Where's he coming in at and what's he gonna do?
He's going to advance, I think. He advances from here. Yeah, I think... yeah, he'll advance. Advance up behind this infantry section.
Okay. So, from where he is...
So, 9 on.
Yeah.
Brings him
catch this.
Right
yes,
up
can.
Behind him.
Yep, perfect.
So, he's just in behind that tree there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What are you going to shoot at from there? Oh.
We're going to go at your half-track.
Oh, the half-track here?
Yeah.
Okay, with the light anti-tank gun?
Not confident with... The medium anti-tank gun on the Panther.
Yeah, so moved and light cover because you have troops in the way, I'm going to say.
Yep.
So that's going to be 5s.
Mm-hmm.
2.
Again?
Yeah.
Again?
Can't get good dice these days.
No, really can't.
You know, they say you can't get the staff, you can't get the dice.
Can't get the dice to do it. Right, all right, go on.
2.
Me again.
What the hell? Did you stack this bag?
Clearly.
Well, you've only got 4 activations left in there.
I know. That's what's worrying me.
Where to?
Sherman's done.
Sherman. Ah, really, you're doing that bit?
It kills me every time inside.
Yeah.
We have the final one over there.
Mm-hmm. Can he do anything worthwhile?
Yes.
Oh, dear.
Yes, he can.
What?
He's going to be issued a fire order,
okay.
But he needs to pass a check first.
Okay.
Because he has 2 pins.
Okay, so he's got a fire order, 2 pins.
So he needs to roll morale.
Uh-huh, roll away.
6, 7, 8, 9.
He's a regular, isn't he?
He's regular, yeah.
With 2 pins?
I don't think he'll make that. I don't think that's it.
No, he goes down.
He failed, so. Nuts. Unfortunate.
You again!
What the?
Okay. I'm not kidding you. Look inside that bag.
Yeah, okay.
You know, I have blue dice in here, I swear. This is not camera trickery.
Yeah.
You know, you're not watching Penn & Teller fool us.
Right. Daimler, going to be issued a fire order.
Okay.
Onto your half track.
Okay.
Because
the squad inside.
Yep, because it's got a bunch of dudes inside. Oh.
Yep.
Yeah, get your fire order in.
So, one shot, you've not moved, I have no
blank.
Cover, and point blank. Mm-hmm. So, hit it. 5, that'll do it.
Yep, that's hit. Light anti-tank gun against a carrier. One.
I doubt if a one's going to do it. No. So a carrier is 7, a light anti-tank gun is 4.
No.
So not going to do it. No. So bong.
Bonk.
But no, he's regular, so we're ignoring that rule at the minute because we're not sure how it works.
Mm-hmm.
Which is okay.
It's over to you again.
Well, we'll see.
It's over to the bag again.
You have 3 dice in here.
Yep.
Me. Okay, I'm going to have to be clever here. So, this little guy down the back here, if I can find him. Ah, here he is.
Mm-hmm.
So this guy down the back here is going to get issued a run order because I need to get him up into position to actually help. So from where he is,
yep,
he's just going to run right up behind his squad.
Yep.
And just hide behind them.
Mm-hmm.
As a good commander does, you know, you don't get in front of your men.
You don't get in their way.
So he has run.
Uh-huh.
And what I'm hoping is that I'll get to go again here, which I do.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to activate this squad here with the 2 pins, but now he's helping.
Yep.
And they'll get a fire order to try and throw a satchel charge in here again and get you cleared.
Okay.
So, leadership task -1.
Yep.
Come on. Okay, and it will do.
Yep.
Thankfully, with that that extra one that he was providing, that actually just about got me.
Yep.
So a pin off, social charge is in.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, you're dead.
Yep.
4, 5, you bail out. 6, you throw the charge back in my face.
Mm-hmm.
And 4. So
I get out.
Yeah.
So what we'll do in this
instance... pins.
Yeah, what we'll do in this instance then is that this section... will have to be at least outside the door.
Yes.
Okay, so they'll have balled out.
Yep. And 3 pins.
And 3 pins with them. So they all just sort of get out the doorway.
Yep.
And then they'll take that pin with them and they'll get 3 more.
There you go. Interesting.
I kind of like how that rule works. That's like, you know, your breach and clear sort of thing. That very quick... bang! Get everyone in, or get, you know, kill everyone inside, or get them to get out. So,
yeah,
right.
It actually is working really well for this.
Mm.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
So more dice.
Yep.
More dice.
You again.
So the unit that I have down the front here.
Yep.
I'm gonna have them bail out.
Okay.
Because I don't want them left inside an immobilized half track.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just gonna run. So furthest point. I can get to is here. Am I out of your minefield?
Nope.
No? So I will have to take a mine test. Mm-hmm. But let me get everybody else there first. So run. And then everybody else is running with them. But I'm hoping that might give me a bit of support across this side next turn. Okay. So now I have to test for the mine. So mm-hmm. It's on 6.
Yep.
And we haven't figured out how it works with infantry.
I'm thinking
D3 or D6 casualties if I hit it.
I'm thinking because
a mine goes off under an infantryman, there's going
to
be death.
And you don't know how many people are going to try tread on a mine as they're running across here. So
exactly.
Let's say D3 wounds.
Okay.
And D3 pins.
Done.
Okay.
Yeah, because your mates are flying everywhere.
Yeah.
If I hit it.
If one guy hits a mine, you're going to immediately stop.
1.
So you don't.
Light-footed and nimble as cats.
Yep.
That is fine.
Great.
Okay?
Yep, back to the bag.
Yeah. Tis I again. Oh, I'm going to be crazy here, right? Mm-hmm. So, I know you'll have hard cover, but I think I need to do this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, Tiger...
Panther.
Oh, Panther, sorry.
Yep.
And is just going to fire off his medium machine gun at you.
Okay.
So, just a fire order. Now, it is a standard medium machine gun, so I am left to wonder, does it get Hitler's buzzsaw?
Well, it's an MG34. I would say it would, but some people tell me that the vehicle-mounted ones don't get it.
Mm.
But that seems silly to me, because it's the same machine gun that's just in a vehicle instead. Perhaps that's a balance issue, I don't know.
Right, well, tell you what, house rule it. Seeing as you're being shot at, you make the call.
I'll give you it.
Okay, so that's 6
I'm
shots.
I'm happy enough for that. Yeah, go for it.
Okay, so I've moved, you're in hard cover, that's 6s. So it's a long shot anyway. I got 1.
Yep.
So there's a pin on those guys now.
Mm-hmm.
You take that. then I have to roll to kill somebody. Four. One. So just one guy. Oh, no, they're veterans.
They are.
So it's fives.
So it's five, so nobody. They just take the pin.
Yeah, they just take the pin. That's still okay for me. Yeah. It means they're less likely to act.
Yep.
You have three, I have four left.
Mm-hmm.
Me again.
Mm.
You know what? Panzer IV will repeat the process.
Mm-hmm.
With its. Just a fire order, fire order, fire order. That's another six.
Mm-hmm.
This time needing fives because I haven't moved. Nada.
Nada.
That's the one thing I find. You see, as soon as you get infantry into hardcover, they are deadly to shift.
Yeah, especially veterans.
Especially veterans, yeah. It was even worse in the conflict game we played.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Okay, so it's me again.
You're really burning your orders out here.
Yeah, but so were you earlier in the turn.
Yeah.
That martyr's just pinned.
Yeah.
Or is he immobilized?
He's immobilized.
He's immobilized, aye. So was that immobilized?
No, that was destroyed. It was immobilized, then I shot it with the tank.
Yeah. All right. I'm actually going to try and fire with the martyr, because there's a Sherman up there that I don't really like.
Yep, true.
So there's my fire order. So fire order here. Two dice test. He's in my second wave, so regular or veteran?
He's veteran in your second wave.
Okay. So 10 minus 2, I need 8 or less.
Mm-hmm.
10.
Sheesh.
Nope, he will go down.
Yep.
He does not like it today.
They just had their tracks blowing off and they're in a very flimsy light vehicle. Of course they're going to freak out a little bit.
The water's coming in around them.
Tide's coming up. We should have had a tide roll.
Again.
Goodness sake. Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they say there's... they say the definition of insanity is repeating the same process over and over again and hoping for a different result. I disagree with this in wargaming. So I'm going to have my light anti-tank gun shoot your
carrier again, yep.
Just to see if I can get rid of it, because it is a medium machine gun, and it could do a lot of damage to this squad.
No, it's an LMG.
Well, still, it's an MG. It's still possibly going to hurt. So that will be one shot,
mm-hmm.
Needing a four, because you are behind cover.
No, oh, missed.
Damn you. Can't roll for toffee. Back to you.
Yep. Okay.
2-1.
Yep.
In your favor now.
Right, this infantry section, I think...
Yeah,
I don't like that now, because you've now got infantry nearby.
Yeah, exactly why I put them there. Yep. And I'm making you think about it.
Yeah.
So, we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, I'm going to bring this infantry section at the advance.
Okay.
And you're just going to have to push forward and start to engage now. Mm. So, here we go. 6 inches brings them to there.
Yeah. See a brown gun.
Yep.
Yep. And I'm guessing your NCO just has a rifle, or does he have a submachine gun?
He's a rifle.
Okay. So three rifle shots and a LMG.
Three rifle and four LMG?
Yep.
Yeah, one more red dice, please. Okay.
So you have moved.
Yes.
I have no cover, so it's force. Two?
Two hits.
But it is a pin.
Yep.
Which is important.
Two hits, yep. Now two wounds.
In fours, one guy dies.
One dead.
So, someone at the back can go.
Yep.
What? Ebhart?
Huh?
Ebhart?
Eberhardt.
Okay. Eberhardt has passed away. I'll put him at the front of the table just so he can mourn and watch everybody. Yeah. Watch the rest of his friends and finish the battle.
More dice! Hurry up!
Calm down.
I need to beat you.
Right, so it's 1-on-1 on the bag now.
Yep. Done. Carrier over there chilling like a boss.
Yeah. Carrier over here chilling like a boss.
Their leadership's not looking great. Mm-hmm. These guys are going to rally.
Okay.
So it's...
D6.
D6.
Plus 1.
D6 plus 1. Two. So 3.
3, yes. So that satchel charge never happened. Come on, lads. Back in. We can do this.
Yep.
Okay. So, in the bag. You do only have one activation left, John, and it's now.
This infantry section is going to fire on these guys.
Okay, so here to here?
Yep.
Okay.
So they're just getting a fire order.
Okay. And they have no pins on them.
Nope, so that's two SMG and four rifle.
Yep. So no cover, not move three. This should hurt.
Two misses.
That's another pin on them, though.
One pin, four wins.
Yeah.
One.
Okay, one guy dies.
Mm-hmm.
So you will die. And Slim.
Okay.
You've gone to Valhalla.
So that is my last activation?
Yep. There's one left, which is me.
Okay.
And for my last activation, I'm coming right to the back of the board again, to this commander here.
Yep.
Who's getting a run order.
Yeah.
The dice beside him. Okay, so that's another turn down. We have one to go.
Yep.
Things are looking very dicey at the minute for both of us.
They are.
So, guys, myself and John take a quick break. Tidy up. We'll be right back. All right, everybody. Time for the final turn. Things are coming right down to the wire here.
Yep.
So, or do you want to?
No, you go ahead.
You.
Thank you.
Damn!
Mm-hmm. This Sherman back here is going to get an advance order.
Okay, so the one right behind the train car?
Yes.
What are you thinking of? Is this that moment of there's no kill like overkill?
There is no kill like overkill. So he's getting to here.
Uh-huh.
A bit further.
What are you shooting at?
You have a unit over here.
Okay, I'm going to call cover for your guys in the way.
Well, actually, maybe not. He's going to do something crazier. So he's going to have got to about here with his turn.
Yeah. And shoot.
And shoot the panther.
In his side, okay. Mm-hmm.
Just because it looks cool. So he's advanced.
Aye.
We have one shot. We've moved. You're in the open.
Not quite. Ish.
Well, no, there's a vehicle intervening. So
you have a vehicle intervening. So you're having to fire over your own guys.
Yep, okay, so a bit of cover.
So four.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Doesn't matter what we do. We roll a two whenever we're trying to hit or damage. It's weird.
Fine, go on. Get us the next one out then.
Aye, aye. I'm hoping it's me. It is me.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm going to go straight to the middle. No hanging about. This squad's getting an advance order to get them in there.
Mm-hmm.
So, I need to roll two dice on a 8 or less because the leader is there. Oh, come on!
Wow.
It's not a foobar, though.
No, it's not.
It is not a foobar, which I can live with.
Mm-hmm.
So they will go down, which will make them harder to hurt.
Yep.
John, can I trade dice with you? I
need nope.
Low, I need low rollers for my morale test.
Yeah. Nope.
You.
Sweet. Okay, boys. Over the top we go. So this section's getting an advance.
Alright. Hopping the hedge.
Yep. They're going to ball right over.
Mm-hmm. And point blank.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Let Jerry have it, boys. Two shots from SMG, four rifles, all point blank.
Yeah. But you have moved.
But I have moved, but point blank reduces that.
Yeah, so it ignores
it's
it.
Negative, so it's a three.
Threes you're after.
One, two misses.
Four hits.
Four hits, so take
four's,
a pin.
Fours to kill.
And fours to kill. That's three two dead. Sixes. That's three dead plus two possible exceptionals.
Yeah. If you got to reroll them.
So reroll these. One exceptional.
Who will it be?
Your NCO. No. Do you have an LMG in there?
I think, yeah, possibly. Oh, no, he died.
No, he's gone. So,
NCO?
Yeah, the guy carrying the Sturmgewehr.
Okay. Now, with the way the rules work, my training allows me to try and save him. Mm-hmm. So, on a roll of a one,
yep.
He's dead. Mm-hmm. On a roll of a two up, it's somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
But you roll one. No, someone else.
Okay.
But it is still three guys, yeah?
Yeah.
One, two, three, that's half the unit.
Mm-hmm.
So that will be a test. Which I'll take now. So it's leadership minus three, but it's actually leadership minus two because of my second lieutenant who's there.
Yep.
So regular guys looking for seven or less to hang about. Seven on the nose.
Yep, so they stay there.
Thank you.
That's fine. So they've ran in.
Right, they've done their thing.
Next dice.
Yeah, next dice out the bag.
Huzzah.
Damn it.
Yep. This infantry section are going to move back into here.
Okay, so this infantry section is coming back in.
Yep.
Okay.
So they're just advancing.
Yep.
They need to pass leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Leadership minus one.
Nine.
Did they feel that?
They're
veteran.
If they're there from the start, they're veteran.
Yep.
Have they lost their NCO?
No, I wouldn't have taken the NCO out on purpose, so...
Right. Then it's nine from veterans, ten.
So they're fine.
Yeah.
So they'll advance back in.
And they'll drop that last pin.
Yep. Okay. So let's get them all bunched up against the window.
Yeah, this'll be interesting.
Ha-ha!
Aye. Hey.
Jerry, we have taken a bunker back. Okay, so we have an LMG in there with four.
So where are you shooting here?
These guys.
Okay.
So LMG with four.
Yeah.
And two rifles? Yeah, two rifles.
Yeah. So six shots total. You've moved. We're right against it, point blank. So threes.
Yep. One miss, two misses.
So four hits.
Four hits, so there's another pin.
Fourth pin. I don't know why. I always think as soon as you take pins equal to or more than you're gonna, you just bugger off.
Yeah.
I can't remember.
I'm pretty sure you almost do, but...
Oh, well.
One dead.
One dead. Okay.
That's definitely another check. I'm pretty sure you're gone at this point because you have four pins and two guys left.
Yeah.
You have more pins than what's in the unit.
Will I take a test?
Do you want to actually check pinning and see?
Let's quickly look.
Well, just quickly, because if we can clarify it now, then we'll know that we've done it wrong earlier. So it's morale value.
Its original morale value is what sends you scarpering.
Okay.
Not unit numbers.
Yeah. Right.
So, if that's been one that you've argued in your clubs, point them this way.
Yep. Okay.
Right. Dice.
Yeah.
Me.
You.
Me. I'm trying to be clever with this. So, I'll tell you what. I am going to go right to the back of the field again. I'm going to try and get this unit up here to activate. So these guys. So they're on a regular advance order. Minus one, plus one. So the order test is nine or less. Come on! What is that? Seriously, what is that?
11. That's what that is, Justin.
Yes, that is false sorcerer. I'm just happy it wasn't a foobar.
That's
again.
A horrendous fail.
That's nuts, because I've done that twice now.
All right, next.
Yeah, next.
You. Back to me. Firefly, you're in you're way out of position here, so...
Well, I don't know, you could still take a pop at the Panther.
He's going to advance anyway.
All right.
So he's going to take his 9-inch move here.
Aye.
And... Oh. He's going to nose his way around to here.
Mm-hmm.
And say, hello, boys.
Mm-hmm.
And then take a shot at the Panther again.
Okay.
Because in reality, Firefly should be looking at the biggest tank going, you're mine.
Mm.
So I've tried to keep him focused on that.
Okay, you've moved, so...
Moved.
Car's still in the way.
Yep.
So five.
Yep. Way.
He hits.
We finally hit with the Firefly.
Oh god, this is gonna suck. Okay, so, it's taken two pins so far.
Yep.
Yeah.
It now needs a morale check.
It's a veteran, so minus two.
Mm-hmm.
So it's eight or less on two.
Yep.
That'll be seven.
Seven.
So the fire's out, but it's got two pins on it.
Yep.
I'll live with that.
Firefly did some good there, though.
Yeah, that's the thing, though. The Firefly is the big shiny in your arm, but there are times when it does nothing to you again. Take it.
Yes.
No, hang on. You have 3 dice left in here.
Yes.
You know how many dice I have?
How many?
7.
Well, I don't see anything wrong with this. I like where this is going.
Especially because it's me doing the drawing.
Yeah.
All right, anyway, yours.
Mm-hmm.
What do you have left?
I have another tank over here.
Another tank over there?
Yeah.
Okay. What is your other tank going to do?
He's going to advance.
Okay.
I know I said I wouldn't turn this into the tank fight that everyone wanted me to, but I lied. So this is going to become a bit of a tank fight.
Okay.
So 9 gets you to there.
Yep.
I just like the look of that. The 3 Shermans are all just like, that thing
There's
over
a
there!
They're over there. Boom. All right, so you've moved cover, so 5.
Yep.
4 misses.
Misses, that's all right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Time to try and go for the win here. All right, so let me go here. I'm going to move this stuff out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
My officer's going to activate.
Mm-hmm.
Going to advance. I throw a satchel charge in.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to roll that. I'm hoping I can get them out of here this turn. So, 6.
6. So I've noticed this happening, grabbed it as you've thrown it in and thrown it back out.
Yeah, and now I take D3 pins on him.
Yep.
1.
Yep.
Oh, that sucks. That sucks.
This has been an interesting little mechanic we chucked into this. I'm quite liking it.
Yeah. You?
Okay.
You have 2 dice to my 6. This is weird.
The end of the game is all you trying to...
It's me making those last pushes.
Yep. All right, this infantry section here will open fire on them again.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I mean, unless... No. I'll advance.
Advance?
Yeah, we're going to advance.
Okay.
So...
Where are you going?
6 inches into the bunker.
Oh, right. So you're just loading everybody you can in?
Yep, so 6 inches gets that guy in.
Yep.
Gets him in through the door so he can scooch around there.
Yeah.
Gets you in through the door and scooches you to there.
Uh-huh.
Ren Gunner in the door too. You and you're basically at the door.
Okay.
Are you annoyed?
Actually, no, because I think I can work with that.
Okay.
Because... you've only a couple of activations left.
I'm consolidating what I have left.
But I think this is the flaw. So, I'm going to go up to the top end of the table. Again, up to this guy.
Yep.
He's going to get his advance order.
And he's going to satchel charge too.
He's going to satchel charge. Because if I can empty those bunkers out, I control one. You're not controlling any of the others.
Mm-hmm.
And that should do it. So, 1, 2, 3 I'm hoping for. In fact, give me one of your black dice.
Go for it.
They've been rolling crap for you all day.
5.
D3 pins. Yep. Onto you. And you do jump out.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So I get out.
And the D3 pins. 3 pins.
Yep.
They haven't activated this turn, have they?
No.
That puts 4 pins onto them.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. Good, good, good.
That's 4. Yep. Give me another 3.
There's 2. Is there anywhere we're not really using them at the
martyr.
Minute? Martyr? Martyr? Yeah, alright.
Take one off the martyr. We know it has 2 and it's not doing much at the minute.
Yeah. Yeah, this is now sort of sewn up for me at this end.
Yeah.
Okay. Me again?
Mm-hmm.
So, this unit in the middle you were going to shoot at.
Yep.
Advance. Because I think I may be able to get one of them into range.
We need to get one of them to the door or something.
Is there?
Yeah.
So is that close enough, would you say, to fire a satchel charge in?
I'm happy enough for you to go for it, yeah.
Alright, let me bring everybody else up.
But I mean, you're stood in the face of a bunch of dudes.
Yeah.
So...
shall we say 5 or 6 that it's chucked back at me then? Just because there's so many guys in there now?
Yeah.
Satchel charge to the rescue! 3. So dead.
1, 2, or 3, yeah. You've cleared the room.
Yeah. But I can't get in to take the room.
Yeah. So Everybody in here is gone.
Yeah. So, boom. Right, I'll take those two dice.
My own rule comes to bite me.
Yeah. But I love the way you were just going, I really like this rule. It's constantly working against Justin. Oh, wait.
No, it does. It is a really good rule.
It works really well, yeah.
I like it.
No, it does work really well. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is that your last one? No, it's not.
What, the advance on the carriers are 9?
9, yeah. You can get within range to actually just nip in past me.
Yep. And get him to there.
Yep.
So the carrier advanced, and yep. Then he'll fire his LMG.
At the squad, I assume?
Yep.
Okay, so that's 5 shots, I believe.
Yep.
No,
4.
Is it?
It's an LMG, not an MMG.
Yes, it's 4. Sorry, I'm not used to playing with the German ones. I just always assume LMG has 5.
Yep. 4 hits.
Ooh. Okay.
I'll never roll like that again.
Yep. So, did these guys have a pin on them?
They did.
Okay, I should have rolled for them. Let me do that now. So, 9 or less.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh. Just about.
Yeah, they got it. They got it, so get rid of that pin.
All right. Well, that pin now goes back on because they've been hit.
All right, yeah. And to wound.
Yeah.
3 dead.
Yeah. So I'll take the 3 guys from the rear, which is fine.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not half the unit, which is okay.
Yep. Then it's over to the bag again.
Mm-hmm. Me?
Yep.
Well, they do say there's no kill like overkill. So what I'm going to be doing is, up here, just going to squeeze off with the MMG.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll be 6 shots.
Yep.
In fives. Oh no, 4s.
4s.
Oh no, 5s.
5s.
Hardcover.
Yep.
Okay, that'll be 3, 4.
Mm-hmm.
That will be a pin on them, so that's 5 pins there up too, which I can live with.
Yep.
And it's 5 to kill. Nobody dies, but it is 5 pins.
Yep.
So I'll grab the other one off the martyr, because I'm not going to do anything with it.
You didn't roll your morale.
Order test.
Yep, your order test.
So, veteran, 8 or less. He's fine.
Yep.
So he drops one.
He drops one, which you can give to me.
Yeah. I'll put that back down there. You get that. Jobs are good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, basically, I'm just trying to lock you down so you cannot get back in there.
Yep.
Me again.
Mm-hmm.
So, same again. Another 6 shots into that unit.
Yep.
Because if I can lock them down and keep them out, I think that'll actually bring us to a tie.
Yeah.
Yep, so there's...
Good hits.
3 hits. And...
I'll take that pin.
Pin for you. 5 to kill. 2 dead.
2 dead, so the 2 rifle back front. Yep.
That's fine. That's 6 pins on them.
Yeah.
Which I think is exactly what I needed to do there.
Yeah.
So... Not much left in the bag. Martyr, you do not matter right now. You're irrelevant to me, Martyr. Don't start playing about. It's your last order, John.
Okay. My very last order.
Yeah.
This infantry section is going to have to get out.
Yeah, and bail in.
And do a run.
Yep.
Or can you run from a vehicle?
It's an open top, so I would assume you don't really have any hindrance to getting out and booking it.
For safety's sake, for rule's sake, I'll advance. Okay. I have enough space to advance.
Yeah, and get in.
So, but can I pass so close to...
Do you have width for your base?
Yeah.
That's what I would say.
Yeah.
Because I would say, yeah, you have enough space there to get past with a base and then some. So you can just nip in the door and go, oi, this is our place. So yep. You've got one guy inside.
One guy in.
And the rest are just going to turn and shoot that squad, I assume.
Yeah. I'm going to get the SMG in there too.
Yeah. And I mean, like, with this being a friendly, fun scenario, it's okay to sort of bend and jig with stuff a little bit.
Yeah. Right, let's advance and let's open fire then.
Okay.
So, 4 rifles and an SMG.
Okay.
Sorry, sniper team, that I haven't used.
Yeah, the sniper team actually got completely forgot about after that first time.
They did one pop, but the problem with it is that they had nothing after that. Mm. They had no targets.
The other thing is, it's that continuously degrading number of orders that you have.
Yeah.
I like that little bit of a thing that we did to it.
You have to prioritize what units you're going to use.
Mm-hmm. And then you have some stuff that just will not get the ACK. I mean, like, that unit that I put down the front there, I've not needed to do anything with them now, which has freed up so much else for me.
Yep. Right, here go. Two hits.
Uh-huh.
Pretty much.
Yep.
Because we moved, but we're in point blank.
Yep. So those guys now have two pins on them, which won't matter. How many die?
Two hits we took, yeah.
Yep. So fours.
Two dead.
Two dead. Take the two from the back.
Uh-huh.
Thankfully not half the unit in one go.
So that's two pins on them and...
Two orders left for me.
Yep.
Hmm. Right. I don't really have much options left here.
Nope.
You know, so what I'm going to do, which is possibly a silly thing, is... Actually, no, there's nothing really I can do that would be worth anything. I think it's game as is.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, so I'm going to call it that, John.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have a final look over the battlefield, okay?
Yep.
So, on this side, I have this bunker under my control.
Yep.
You have this bunker under your control.
Yep.
Neither one of us controls this bunker.
It's contested.
Yep.
Yep.
So that's a tie.
It well is played. Actually a very close tie, too.
That
although
was very well played.
You took four order dice off me, and I only took one off you.
Yeah. I mean, like, most beach landings people talk about, they always say, oh, whoever's attacking dies in droves. Not really, if you do it right.
No, if you do it fairly.
Mm.
That I think that was a fair scenario to do a beach landing with.
Yeah, and it was an asymmetrical scenario as well. So we weren't worried about points. We were just saying, look, here's what we have. Here's what we think would be landing at this point. Here's what we think would work for a landing at this point. And I think it's worked really well.
Yeah, talking out a narrative game seems to be a nice way to play bull action at the minute.
Yeah, and the few twists that we put in there, I think, worked really well for the game. So
the satchel charges everywhere.
Satchel charges worked really well.
Yep.
Landmines was fantastic because it was
fun.
It was a hindrance. It was an annoyance. It made me take risks. You know, and then having the flat 10 dice to play with for this scenario, I think worked really well as well. I think that's the only things we really changed.
Pretty much, yeah.
Mm. All right, well, guys, I'll tell you what. Drop your comments in below. Did you enjoy that demo game? Do you think there's any tactics around myself and John missed? I know there's a few of the extra order bits that we could use with our commanders and stuff, but I just wanted to keep this a nice, simple, light game.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that worked out really well. Myself and John will move on here, and we'll see you in another video.
In a world controlled by massive corporations, a steady aim and split-second decisions are needed for your Megacon to complete its goals. Begin your missions at the Mercs Hub on beastofwar.com. Progress comes to a world of magic as science and the arcane combine to make marvels. Meet steampunk inventors and orc mystics at the Volsung Hub on beastofwar.com.